Gentlemen, we've said it all. We know what we are. That cocoon, it's been shed. You look like you're ready for a show. You dressed the part. Now let's go be the part.
Welcome to ESPNU College Football Primetime, presented by McDonald's. Tonight, we're in Tallahassee as the South Carolina State Bulldogs take on the Florida A&M Rattlers. Standings in the MEAC a little bit twisted this year. South Carolina State off to a horrific start, while Florida A&M has played well, winning three of their first four conference games. You see North Carolina Central at the top with a perfect 4-0 mark. With former NFL and Howard quarterback Jay Skywalker, Wayne Rantazzo here at Bragg Memorial Stadium. And Jay, the standings out of whack this year in the MEAC.
Yeah, North Carolina Central's really taking the conference by storm, getting off to a great start. South Carolina State, one of the traditional powers in the MEAC conference, stumbled out the block. They've got to try and turn their season around, while Florida A&M, although they're 3-4 overall, they still control their own destiny in terms of the MEAC conference. If they can win the remainder of their games, they can be crowned the MEAC champions.
South Carolina State has struggled offensively so far, so they're going to try to go back to basics, get their running game involved with Jalen Simmons.
And that's what they have to do. For so many years, the Bulldog offense was predicated on a strong, solid running game. They need Jalen Simmons to find that type of form with the offensive line tonight to get them going in the right direction. They've been so reliant upon the pass, and the quarterback play has not been where they would like it to be, so look for the Bulldogs to try and pound the football tonight.
FAMU's been firing the ball all over the place with sophomore quarterback Damian Fleming, and Jay, a quarterback that you believe could be the first draft pick from the MEAC at the quarterback position since you.
Yeah, he's that type of talent. He's got everything you like in a quarterback. The size is there, 6'4.5", strong arm, good mobility. But what I really like about Damian Fleming, his decision with the football. He's thrown one interception in his past 145 pass attempts. That tells you he knows where to go with the football. They've got a special talent in Damian Fleming here in Tallahassee.
Back in Tallahassee, Florida, FAMU has won the toss, and they will receive. Will Roper will kick it off for South Carolina State. James Owens waits for the kick for FAMU. Wayne Randazzo with Jay Walker. Bragg Memorial Stadium in a MEAC showdown. South Carolina State trying to avoid their third consecutive loss. Owens will watch this one bounce into the end zone and go out of bounds. So it's a touchback, and now Florida A&M will set up shop on their own 20-yard line, led by their sophomore quarterback, Damian Fleming.
And we talked about what Fleming can do with the football and his decision-making skills. One of the new wrinkles, I think, that South Carolina State's going to face on defense that other teams have not in the season this far is the location of number two, Travis Harvey, his go-to wide receiver. They used to line him up solely as the X receiver. And when I talked to Coach Taylor and the offensive staff, they plan on moving Travis Harvey around the football field many different positions today.
Fleming, only a sophomore out of Jacksonville. Harvey is in there on the near side to your screen. Harvey and Linworth Lennon have had a big season combined. First play from scrimmage, a pass, and that one out of the reach of the intended receiver. That was the other Harvey on that one, Dwayne Harvey. We take a look at Travis Harvey, MU's wide receiver, who has averaged nearly 86 yards per game to lead the MEAC.
Special talent. We saw in the first play they lined him up at the Z spot compared to the X receiver, but he can really do it. He's a game breaker, Damian Fleming's favorite target. On the defensive side of the ball, Justin Hughes from South Carolina State. The Bulldog defender's got to be all over the field. More importantly, he's got to stop the running game when FAMU tries to run the football.
Second down, Fleming from the gun. Moves it up the middle. That one is caught and then knocked out. It's ruled a fumble right now, no whistle. And finally, the ball is deadened inside the 30-yard line with South Carolina State in possession. As the call on the field is right now, it's Bulldog football.
And I'm pretty sure this is one that the replay booth is going to take a look at. Fleming tries to throw the ball underneath. He gets the ball. He makes a foot before he can secure the football. Seems as if the Bulldog defender knocked it out of there. I would challenge it either way if I was one of the coaches for both teams. I think one of the things that needs to be noted, the MEAC conference is the only conference in FCS football that has instant replay for all of its televised games. The officials can go to the booth to review it, and I'm pretty sure they're going to take a look at this one.
There's Jeremy White, who ended up with what is right now a fumble recovery, and it will be reviewed upstairs. So right away, 16 seconds into this game, Jay, we have our first review.
And this could be a turning point in the game early on in the football contest. He's got the ball. One, two. I think that fumble's going to stand. Now, I'm probably about 15% on the year in getting these correct, but it was a good hit with the helmet put on the ball, trying to throw the ball underneath.
Good angle here, if you could see that he tucked it there and then kind of lose it. Did he have possession once he tucked it, really the question. Hard to tell if he ever really had it. He may have, Jay.
Yeah, but then, you know, when you look at it there at the end, if you slow it down, it seemed as if there was some movement on the ball on his hip before contact, as if he was having trouble holding on and securing that football. The ball might have been wiggling a little bit before contact was made.
As always, the ruling on the field is what's important. It was ruled a fumble, so now there has to be enough video evidence to overturn that. As Clement Hall, our head official, takes a look and now has a decision.
After review, the play is reversed. Incomplete pass, second down.
So it sticks with FAMU. The offense will return to the field. White does not get the fumble recovery as he thought. Take a look at Buddy Poe, the head coach for South Carolina State. A couple of national championship winning coaches on each end. Buddy Pugh and Joe Taylor on the other side. Four national championships in Joe Taylor's career. He has the most wins in MEAC history.
That's a lot of W's between those two guys. So when you come into a game like this, you'd like to think the players are going to determine the outcome. No team is going to outcoach the other.
So FAMU gets kind of a redo here, but it is third and 10 after the incomplete pass. A couple of incompletions so far for Damian Fleming. Jay, what are some of the things you really like about Fleming?
Poise, decision making. He doesn't get rattled. You know, against a very aggressive defense like South Carolina State's been, he'll stand tall in the pocket. And what he's really done this year is he added the wrinkle of the mobility. Not afraid to take off and run the football. He's a better athlete than I thought he was.
Take a look at the clock here. As that's what they're reviewing.
So if
to
that's
see
an incomplete pass, then the clock should have stopped at around 14 minutes and 50 seconds.
Right.
The game clock here is showing 14:44.
So they'll get that figured out, but it still says 14:44 in the game clock. Third down, Fleming looking to pass, steps up and throws low, and the one is caught. Going down to catch it, Dwayne Harvey making the stumbling grab. And while short of the first down, FAMU does get positive yardage for the first time as the tackle was made by Alex Glover.
And that's one there where although the Rattlers did not convert on third down, they'll take it. In a game like this where field position could become important, you don't want to give the visiting team great field position to start off the contest.
Brandon Holdren, a punt. And back deep, Darius Drummond for South Carolina State. Good rush, but the punt gets away from Holdren. Backing up to grab it, Stephen Murphy. Trying to turn the corner. Murphy has some room and goes out of bounds near the 40-yard line. Pretty good return by Stephen Murphy. 18-yard pickup. And now South Carolina State will get their offense on the field for the very first time.
Let's take a look at this punt return, and this is what you call poor coverage. You do not allow the receiver, if you're the gunner, to get outside you. You're going to see an outside number 16 for Florida A&M, Adrian Cole. You get beat to the outside. His job is to make everything go into the inside. He didn't. Poor position. They were able to get the ball back with a decent return.
Good field position for the Bulldogs. Their own 40-yard line. Jalen Simmons in there, a tailback. Snap to the quarterback, Richard Q. Play action. And into traffic, that one is received for a first down at the 42-yard line, a 19-yard pickup. Catch made by Tamarick Hemingway, the tight end.
And Hemingway's a guy, they say, if they're going to get involved in the passing game. He thought the reason why they struggled so much is because of the lack of a tight end. They've made some changes. Now Hemingway is going to be their go-to target at that position.
Fifth catch this season for Hemingway. A handoff to Simmons, and he gets a couple of yards trying the left side. And as we mentioned in the open, Jay, Jalen Simmons, the man that will be carrying the football quite a bit tonight for South Carolina State.
Yeah, he's got to help out Richard Q, who you see there, their quarterback. Q is leading, you know, he's one of the worst quarterbacks in terms of interceptions this year. South Carolina State as a team as a whole is not doing well. Q's got 11 interceptions with only 4 touchdowns on the season. That's not getting it done at the quarterback position.
Lots of turnovers all the way around. On second down, Q will keep it in the air. Throws deep, and that one too deep over the head of the intended receiver, Linnell Elmore. And Linnell Elmore, our impact player tonight for South Carolina State.
Linnell Elmore was the number one wide receiver for South Carolina State in the 2010 season. Didn't play in 2011. Now he's back for the 2012 campaign. Look for him to be the go-to guy if they want to be able to throw the football. And defensively for Florida A&M, linebacker Brandon Hepburn is simply a good person on and off the field. He's a great football player. They need him not today, not for his academics, but for his football playing abilities down there from the middle linebacker position.
Third down and 7. Q looks to pass, screens it out, and that one is caught. Nice grab, spinning out of a tackle and getting first down yardage. Caleb Davis, a pickup of about 8 and a first down for the Bulldogs.
Great individual effort by Davis. And Davis is a guy who last year in Elmore's absence stepped up and became a big-time wide receiver. You see here, initial contact is behind the first down marker, spins forward and able to pick up the first down with a great second effort.
First down for South Carolina State, driving into FAMU territory. Keep it on the ground here, Simmons up the middle, and Simmons across the 25, a solid first down game. Jalen Simmons, sophomore running back out of Charlotte, the leading rusher. He was tackled there by Brandon Hepburn. Second down, another run for Simmons. This one across the first down marker, gets to the 21. South Carolina State struggling offensively this season, Jay, but so far on their first possession, running the football a lot and moving the chains.
And I like what they did there. They realized they were able to get some control of the line of scrimmage with Simmons running the ball, so they did a hurry up with the same personnel on the field and ran the ball again, not allowing Florida A&M to make defensive substitutions.
Play action. Q looking over the head, but a nice leaping catch by Tyler McDonald. And at the 15-yard line, McDonald goes down. So we'll take a look with South Carolina State inside the 20-yard line. Verizon in the red zone. The Bulldogs 12 drives, 6 touchdowns, 4 field goals, second in the MEAC. They swing it out to the sideline. As that take a look in the red zone, brought to you by Verizon.
This is a part of the field where for South Carolina State, you should be able to run the football with the power package. Simmons has been off to a good start. Continue to feed him the football and allow the line of scrimmage to take control of this 3-4 defensive front 7 for Florida A&M.
Now FAMU's got a bunch up on this third and short. Keeper for Q, and it looks like he has the first down at the 10-yard line. Q, the quarterback, just ducked underneath there, Jay.
As a quarterback, you're taught, stay low. He got himself in trouble when he tried to bounce up to look to see if there was another running lane. But able to pick up the first down. Richard Q, a head scorer from South Carolina State. They got off to such a great start. Big win versus Georgia State. He was the player of the game, was hot. He's just trying to find that hot hand recipe again.
It's first and goal right at the 10-yard line. Give to the backup tailback, Charles Brown. He has some room trying to turn the corner, and he's dragged out of bounds inside the 5. The pickup for Brown, his first touch today, tackled by Devon Roberts. It was not first and goal, it was first and 10, so there is a first down capability inside the 1-yard line. This will be 2nd and 3. Pendergrass in a running back. Snap goes to Pendergrass, straight up the middle, and he gets taken down maybe a yard there for Pendergrass.
Look at this formation by design. This is a wildcat, but what they did, they kept the quarterback in the backfield. So this is Q right here. He's not lined up behind the center. They use him as the fake running back on the jet sweep, trying to cause some confusion. One of the few times I've ever seen the wildcat formation where the quarterback actually stays in the backfield.
You see a bunch of running backs for South Carolina State. They transfer between 4 of them.
Try it again.
Another snap to Pendergrass. This time, he's in the end zone. No, they're going to say he's not. Right on the goal line. As Pendergrass trying to sneak his way in, and right at the last moment, it's close. Did he get that ball in?
Very close. See if is the knee down, knees down. Ball's a little short. Officials might have gotten that one right. It's a bang bang play. Knee comes down, ball's not quite in.
Yep, the knee going down first is what hit Pendergrass out of the end zone. They're going to measure now. There was a first down chance right there at the goal line. That's where they are.
We know he didn't get the touchdown, but if there's any chance he could have gotten the first down without going into the end zone, he would have had it.
Well, he does have the first down by about half the football, so we'll be first and goal. As South Carolina State tries to punch it in, a pretty successful opening drive for the Bulldogs. Pendergrass is the deep back up first and goal. Bulldogs have been successful in the red zone. Not there. Richard Kew, the quarterback, slammed to the ground for a loss. Brandon Hepburn coming up to make the tackle.
What happened to the right side of the South Carolina State offensive line? Tristan Bellamy, the guard, went down. That's where the play was designed to go. Q obviously tried to call his own number and run to the B gap when the quarterback sneak was designed for the A gap.
This is the 14th play of the drive for South Carolina State. Snap to Pendergrass at the goal line. And this time he's in. Touchdown, Julius Pendergrass. On the direct snap, a 2-yard touchdown run to give South Carolina State the early lead.
That's the South Carolina State football that was missing. The ability to run the ball hard between the tackles to pick up positive yards. Running back by committee, Charles Brown, Julius Pendergrass, and Jalen Simmons.
14 play drive, third rushing touchdown this year for Pendergrass. Nick Belcher's extra point attempt slaps through, and it's a 7-0 advantage for South Carolina State. The Bulldogs up in front early as South Carolina State uses a 14 play drive to get ahead. Julius Pendergrass punches it home. ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by McDonald's. I'm loving it. And in part by the all-new Dodge Dart. Dodge, new rules. South Carolina State, an early 7-0 lead. A successful opening drive of 14 plays, 60 yards. Jay, they established the run game. Julius Pendergrass getting in the end zone.
That's what they needed to do. And you knew that head coach Buddy Pugh was going to light the fire underneath the Bulldogs. Coming on the road. Tough place to win a football game. If you can get your offensive line to get the running game going, makes the job that much easier for the quarterback.
Opening drive going well there for South Carolina State. Buddy Pugh, it's Will Roper will kick it off. James Owens waits back. Backpedaling into the end zone. That one's way out of here. Over Owens' head for the second straight time. FAMU will start on their own 20. Roper with a booming lay. South Carolina State, they could use a victory. 1-3 so far in conference play. And off to a good start. They wanted to get that ground game going. They did. And now, defensively, they'll have to try to stop the attack of Damian Fleming in the air, which they did on the opening drive.
Very good opening possession for them, but how long will it last? This is a South Carolina State defense that's missing three of their better defensive players, particularly Joe Thomas, the captain of the defense. He's out, not dressed. Jakar Hamilton, starting strong safety, not dressed. The Bulldogs are banged up on defense.
On the 25-yard line as that one scoots to the 33. Eddie Rocker with his first carry of the game. First time that FAMU has tried to run the football. And Rocker gains 8.
For years, Joe Taylor was known for featuring the running game. And what's happened is when you got a talent like Damian Fleming that comes along, some people think they fell in love with the pass a little bit too soon. Where's that balance between run and pass? And that's the ratio they're looking for. And through it all, we're still 3-1 in conference play.
Second down, back to the ground. Eddie Rocker again bounces out, cuts back. Rocker still on his feet. First down yardage to the 46-yard line. 13-yard pickup for Eddie Rocker, the senior tailback.
That was a great job by Rocker, bouncing this play to the outside. Once you go in the middle, it's not there. Slide to the sideline, then get underneath. Your offensive lineman blocking downfield. Good vision on display by Eddie Rocker, the 5'8", 175-pound senior from Ocala, Florida.
Just over 5 yards per carry. 171 of those yards were last week against Savannah State. First down, another give to Rocker. A little bit of room as he tried the left side, but just a yard or so. Three straight runs now for FAMU after spinning the first possession trying to throw the football.
Something I'm curious about, what you see both teams do when they're in the shotgun formation, running the ball, when you got the spread, I think people have figured out if a guy lines up on the left, they're going to run the ball to the right. If he lines up on the right, they're going to run it left. As a quarterback, I'd be a big fan of the pistol formation. Put him right behind to keep the defense guessing where the running game is going.
Second down, play action. Fleming in trouble, gets rid of it. That one knocked away. Good effort there by McFadden, but a flag comes in. And that could be pass interference against Kamario McFadden.
McFadden might have gotten there just a hair too soon. One thing you're going to get from Damian Fleming are accurate balls. He's very accurate.
Pass interference on the defense. Number 43, 15 yards long. First down.
Off of the play action, you see he's throwing the ball right on the money. That's a close one.
It is close.
Seems as if he got that right hand on the ball first before he made contact with his left arm.
He certainly hooked him after that. The question is, was it there before the football? A big game for FAMU on the penalty. South Carolina State has had issues with penalty yards this year, the most in the MEAC. James Owens in there is one of the split backs. Shotgun as Fleming looks to throw a swing on first down. A few yards there, a big hit. Fleming watching his receiver get unloaded on as Terrell Fitz got punished. Alex Glover with the big smash.
Second down.
Florida A&M, they have certainly thrown the football at will this season, leading the MEAC in all three of those categories. Look at that pass efficiency number, 160.1. Keeping it in the air. Fleming getting away from pressure. First down and more. And Fleming out of bounds at the 20.
That's the added dimension that Damian Fleming has added to his game during his sophomore campaign. Drops back, takes a look, pump fake, it's not there. Quick decision, take off running, and you see the ability to run away from the defenders and pick up the first down.
Gain of 16 for Damian Fleming. Rocker back in at running back and a man in motion. Give to Rocker, cut it back. He gets inside the 15. Good presence there from Rocker. Seeing the hole closing up, took it back the other way.
The patience on display. A younger back would have tried to force the ball to the outside and run into a bunch of black jerseys, but he kept his feet underneath them. Waited till he saw a little hint of daylight. Picked up good yardage.
FAMU trying to answer the South Carolina State score. They've taken the ball into the red zone, down to the 15-yard line.
This is where you got to watch Travis Harvey. He's lined up at the top of your screen. See if they can get him in a one-on-one matchup.
Fleming with a handoff. That one not going anywhere. Rocker taken down at the line of scrimmage. McFadden, the strong safety, moved up and got in on the tackle. Andrew Carter in there as well, the defensive end. Carter, a sophomore. South Carolina State with a young defense. Play a 4-2-5 base. They're strict with that, DJ. They don't care who they're playing. 4-2-5 is the way they're going to go. Florida A&M in the red zone. 16 touchdowns on 28 drives. Sixth in the MEAC. On third down, Fleming looks to pass. Fires over the middle, and that one is knocked away. Batted down by Darius Drummond in the end zone.
Tight window Fleming tried to squeeze that ball into. Had to get rid of it because of pressure by Andrew Carter, number 41. The defensive end is going to come and put a hit on him. And a few times you'll see Damian Fleming make a poor decision where to go with the football. That was pretty good coverage by the Bulldog secondary.
Now the field goal unit comes out. Chase Varnador, sophomore left-footed kicker. 31-yard attempt. And that one is no good. Varnador couldn't connect from 31 yards out. And South Carolina State holds defensively as FAMU comes up empty on a long drive. Still 7-0 Bulldogs.
That's me, L508585844P. But I'm not just a number. I have a purpose, a higher purpose.
Have some respect.
South Carolina State with an early 7-0 lead over Florida A&M. As today marks the third game in Tallahassee this season without the famed FAMU Marching 100 Band, which has been suspended through the school year after drum major Robert Champion died last November following a hazing ritual. One former band member facing charges related to Champion's death is set to be sentenced Monday in Orlando after entering a no-contest plea last week. The others facing charges that are scheduled for trial in 2013. FAMU with alternative entertainment at these games, a trio of DJs here today. And Jay, how have you felt that FAMU has handled this horrible tragedy?
Obviously nothing, you know, nothing positive out of what happened last season, but I think the key is what do you do to try and turn that into something positive you learn going forward. I think Coach Joe Taylor, as well as the administration here at Florida A&M, have said college campuses across the country will become safer because of what happened at Florida A&M, and they're really trying to take it on head on, trying to crack down on college hazing nationwide.
After the missed field goal, Bulldogs from their own 20, and a pass complete over the middle. That's Elmore. Elmore with a big game across the 45, and he's finally wrapped up after a pickup of 26 yards.
What made Linnell Elmore a special wide receiver was he was a converted running back out of high school and became their go-to guy. And what they're going to do is find a way to get him across the formation, get him the ball, and watch him make special things. Hit him in stride, and he knows how to run the football after the catch from his running back days in high school. And that's what they like about Linnell Elmore.
On first down, they put it on the ground. Not much around the corner. FAMU coming up to stuff the run. It was Ashton Jordan who got denied in the backfield.
Jordan is the senior from Somerville, South Carolina. He's their east-west power, I mean their north-south power running back. Surprised they have him running on the edge.
You said there was a fumble at the end of that play and that FAMU has recovered it.
FAMU's ball, first down.
For a turnover, we've seen plenty of those from South Carolina State. Normally they're interceptions, but this time, one that goes on the ground from Ashton Jordan.
They're running sideways and yeah, before he gets down, he did secure the football. He started losing control of it. As the running back, you're trying to hold on to a football between the defender's legs. That's not ball control.
They trying to scoop it back up, but as you mentioned, Jay, trying to go between the defenders there. And I think South Carolina State might want to take another look at that. But from that angle, what we just saw looked pretty evident that that was clearly a fumble.
Timeout. South Carolina State is challenging the ruling on the play.
So the Bulldogs want to see that one reviewed as they maintain a 7-0 lead, trying to maintain possession.
Team is not something you do alone.
South Carolina State with a 7-0 lead. We'll see if they're able to maintain possession here. FAMU takes over offensively in Bulldog territory. A fumble on the field and the FAMU Rattlers trying to take advantage of a turnover as many opponents have for South Carolina State this year.
And that's part of the reason why they're off to such a slow start. You turn over the football, a good team's going to make you pay for it. South Carolina State, although they're a good team traditionally, they're on the opposite side of that statistic.
Handoff on the first play of the drive and not much there. Good tackle as James Owens couldn't get anywhere. Loss on the play. They lost about a yard and a half. Leon Smith with the stop.
Something Florida A&M has to do is get off to a more explosive start. I mean, this is a good offense here. Fleming's the guy, established that in the loss they had versus Howard 2 weeks ago. You know, you've got the best quarterback in the MEAC. You shouldn't be settling for 10 points only. Get it going early when you're not playing catch up from behind.
Fleming just 2 of 5, 6 yards so far. A screen here, and that one was dropped. Travis Harvey had it right in the gut, couldn't hang on.
That's the identity. When you're trying to establish the run, then you want to go to the wide receiver screens out there. Those have to be things that you operate like clockwork. And once again, it seems as if Florida A&M is getting off to a slow start offensively.
Joe Taylor, 10th among active head coaches, 233 career victories. I've seen many drop passes over the years, but his teams have certainly overcome them. Lots of wins in Joe Taylor's tenure. It's his fifth year at FAMU. Fleming looks to air it out, stepping up out of pressure, floats it. Harvey can't reach it. Hit Harvey in the fingertips. Stephen Murphy was there. Harvey couldn't reel it in.
It wouldn't have mattered anyway. He was driven out of bounds by the defensive back, trying to come back in. The official dropped his hat. But you'll see Fleming do a good job of stepping up, trying to buy a little bit more time, throwing the ball. See that hat that's right there? Right away let you know. The official said he stepped out of bounds during the route.
The catch, Jay. Brandon Holdren will punt. Fourth and a dozen, and FAMU's got to get rid of it again. Darius Drummond from the 15. Up the seam. Drummond has room. A flag comes in as Drummond takes off into FAMU territory and finally pulled down at the 41-yard line. That flag about 20 yards back. This one will likely be a hold against South Carolina State. Tyler McDonald with the infraction.
During the return, hold it. Number 2, 10-yard penalty on spot of 5. First down.
Wasn't McDonald, so that negates what could have been a long return by Darius Drummond. BCS Countdown is on ESPN and ESPNU this Sunday, a day after the dust has settled. Our analysts break down the key victories and defeats that took place on the college football gridiron and discuss their impact on the standings. Plus, we look ahead at the key matchups for next week. BCS Countdown at 8:30, then at 9, presented by Tostitos, Sunday on ESPN and ESPNU. Would have been a 24-yard return for Drummond. Now the ball back at the 29-yard line. Simmons, the deep back. He gets the handoff here. Tries to spit away. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. Get a 2nd and 10. Brandon Denmark coming in with the tackle.
Florida A&M runs 3 defensive linemen and 4 linebackers versus a 3-4 front. You should not have your running back getting hit in the backfield. That has been where the struggles have been. But this offensive line for South Carolina State not being physical and establishing control of the line of scrimmage.
Redshirt senior at left guard Sam Hammond is the most experienced of the bunch, as that pass was incomplete and now a flag comes in way late. That one defended by Patrick Aiken. Clement Hall will sort it out. Might be a taunting penalty, Joe.
Hold it. Number 5 of the defense, automatic first down.
That's a defensive hold on Aiken. Came in pretty late, though, for a defensive hold.
Flag was thrown from the back judge. One of those plays there where I thought he got away with it pretty cleanly. Aiken, the freshman from Pembroke Pines, Florida, learning college football is an offensive-minded game. Defenders, more times than not, will not get the break.
A fresh set of downs for South Carolina State up to their own 39-yard line. Give to Simmons. He lunges forward for a few. Jalen Simmons. Jay, they think this guy's got a chance to be one of the next great running backs in South Carolina State history.
For a running back by committee, which was what they did at the beginning of the season, they thought when we can get him going, he can be the total package. We've got smaller backs, we've got a big power back. Simmons is the one that offers the power running with the big play ability to take it the distance on any carry.
It's only a sophomore. Play action. Q gets rid of it. That's Elmore. Across midfield, Elmore stays up. To the 45 into FAMU territory and a first down.
And that was good quarterback play by Richard Q. Coming off the play action pass. Defensive lineman was on him. In that case, he didn't panic. He drew the defender closer to him so he could buy separation to get the ball to Elmore and stride.
Pick up 13 to get a new first down. Out of FAMU territory. Give to Simmons up the middle. Simmons ran into the official, look like, as he does get the first down. Pickup of about 11. Devon Roberts finally bringing him down.
You talk about running in 3D. Jalen Simmons coming right at the official in the teeth of the Florida A&M defense.
First and 10. And now a flag comes in. Some movement on the line, perhaps. False start, looks like, against South Carolina State. Richard Q trying to get his offense on track.
False start. Number 76 in the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Just the first quarter, Jay, but the Bulldogs' offense has moved the ball pretty well.
A number of plays, and what they're doing is every time they catch Florida A&M and the personnel that they feel they have the advantage, they're going hurry up. And we're talking about the turbo hurry up. They're snapping the ball with 20 seconds on the play clock. So they feel like they've got the package that they want in there against the Florida A&M defense. They like the look that they're getting.
Man in motion on first and 15. Play action. Q to pump fake, now in trouble. Q goes down. 2-yard loss on the sack. Ellie Hippolyte, the senior defensive end, taking Q out there.
Yeah, good coverage by the Rattlers secondary. They're going with the play action, only a three-man route, keeping bodies in there for protection, but Florida A&M still manages to get there, and you see down the screen, black jersey surrounding the South Carolina State wide receivers to help the defensive line get the sack.
Second and long for a club that has had interception problems this year. He will try to air it out. A screen pass. And that one read perfectly by FAMU. Jalen Simmons had nowhere to go.
That's how you have to sniff it out there. They're going to try and do misdirection this way and do a slip screen out the back door. But watch the number of black jerseys that recognize this. One guy's in his face, and then once you get the location on it right here, he sees it clearly, and then you've got a backup defender there to make the tackle. That's good defense by the front four. I'm sorry, the front three of Florida A&M, backed up by the four linebackers.
George Elijah Maxey with the tackle. South Carolina State 3-for-3 on third down, but they face third and 23 here. Low snap, it's fumbled. Q falls on it. At the very least, the Bulldogs keep it. Could have been yet another turnover for South Carolina State, but Q alertly jumping on top of the ball. And now they'll just have to punt it as time winds down here in this opening period.
Yeah, and this has got to be disappointing when you've got the ball first and 10 on the 35-yard line, and now you're punting after moving negative yards, giving up what should have been a field goal opportunity. Bulldog offense with miscues, penalties, and then bad snap.
Nick Belcher will punt. Wentworth Lennon back deep. That punt not going very far. Good bounce, though, for the Bulldogs. Lennon comes up to touch it on the bounce. And down to the 27-yard line. So South Carolina State gets the offense rolling early, and they're up 7-0. Florida A&M on ESPNU.
The Mideastern Athletic Conference.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is brought to you by UPS. Search UPS Football on Facebook. Take a look. look at Bragg Memorial Stadium in Tallahassee, where South Carolina State's got an early 7-0 lead on Florida A&M. Second quarter about to start. Wayne Randazzo with Jay Walker. And Jay, South Carolina State's offense clicking a little bit in the first quarter.
The ability to run the football, which was the key. They found some lanes. And think about this. I mean, they kept Florida A&M off the scoreboard. They've got a 7-0 lead, and they had the turnover in the first quarter, so the defense rose to the occasion as well. Coming in here to Tallahassee, tough place to play. Buddy Pugh can't be too upset with the 7-0 lead.
After a punt, FAMU starts on their own 18. They swing it to Owens. Owens dancing, still on his feet, to the 30-yard line, a gain of 12.
That's James Owens. Great wide receiver blocking on the outside by Lennon. And this is going to be a swing pass, but I want you to see all the bodies get a body on a body as they swing Owens out of the backfield. But look at the way that they engaged on the white jerseys. Find them, stalk block. Stalk block, he catches the ball, he sees the crease here, and then just shows some athleticism to make the first defender miss in a small space.
First-year linebacker, first-year starter at linebacker, Justin Hughes. Slow to get up.
And they're thin already at the linebacker position with their best defensive player, Joe Thomas, not playing tonight. Then Joe Hughes, who happens to be the leading tackler for the Bulldogs this year, going to the sidelines. Been one of those seasons for the team from Orangeburg.
Yeah, they've had a lot of defensive injuries especially. And because of that, they've given up a lot of big plays. First down for FAMU. Our 12-yard pickup on the screen pass to Owens. Swing it out again, this time Travis Harvey. He gets pushed out of bounds a couple of yards. McFadden with the push out.
Harvey's going to be one of those guys, they just want to get him his touches. They feel if they can just get him the ball 7 or 8 times a game, he's going to do something dynamic. Trying to manufacture offense from their best wide receiver at that position.
He and Lennon have combined for more than 1,000 receiving yards this year. They've been a good 1-2 punch, two of the top threats at wide receiver in the MEAC. Rockers the deep back. He gets the handoff on second down. Tried to spin away, but good pressure from the South Carolina front. Javon Hargrave with the tackle there.
Get a look there at Tevin Richard. He came in for Justin Hughes, and Richard, 5'11", 200 pounds, but just a freshman. So now this is his first active duty. He's getting taken on an offense that's pretty potent. It's going to be interesting to see how he progresses during this game if Justin Hughes is not able to make a return soon to this football game.
Good bloodlines there. Tevin's brother, Donovan, finished an all-MEAC career as a linebacker for the Bulldogs last year. He's with the Jacksonville Jaguars now. Third and three. Fleming gets rid of it. Looking for Harvey.
What a catch.
And Harvey's got it, plus the flag. Stephen Murphy was all over Harvey. As the referees sort out what exactly happened there. The flag came in right as Harvey was making the grab on the sideline.
Pass interference, number 2 of the offense. 15-yard penalty. See a third down.
Well, that goes against Travis Harvey. He made the incredible catch, but got a little leverage illegally.
Let's see, is there a push right there to get that separation? Oh, man.
Kind of grabbed the front of Murphy's jersey, but that's really it.
He didn't extend out. I mean, he just was trying to readjust his body, and he used the defensive back. Stephen Murphy is a way to readjust and make that catch.
Tough call. What could have been a big play. In Florida A&M, they haven't had many big ones yet. 36 yards taken away by the offensive pass interference. Four receivers set. They'll run it on third down. And a smack as Eddie Rocker got crushed on that play by Courtney Ingram.
Ingram's a guy they bring in there. He plays that kind of dog backer position, which is a hybrid, really like a strong safety. Good job of putting some leather on the ball carrier.
Ingram's a guy they like despite his lack of usual size that you see at the middle linebacker position. He's 5'10", 190. He brought the pain there on Rocker. Fourth down and they'll punt. Holdren will kick it. Murphy back deep. Drummond as well. This one hits for Murphy. And a swing by. Murphy got pulled down from behind. Nice return from Murphy as South Carolina State regains possession after a slam from Courtney Ingram.
Com and enter promo code VORTEX6.
South Carolina State out to an early 7-0 lead at FAMU, and it's now time for Where I'm From, brought to you by the U.S. Marines. FAMU head coach Joe Taylor, native of Washington, D.C., has coached at 4 HBCU schools. His most success at Hampton, 233 career victories. He also coached Howard, where Jay Walker went to school and starred at the quarterback position.
Spent the season on the yard. Virginia Union got them into a playoff contender year in, year out, but that run that he had at Hampton University during from the 2000 all the way to about the 2008 season was remarkable. He had them on the right place year in, year out. Matter of fact, I think they won 3 consecutive MEAC titles.
Hasn't taken long to turn the FAMU program around. Hand off to Elmore. He's got nowhere to go. He was hit immediately and brought down in the backfield by a couple of defenders.
On the jet sweep there, but just good penetration by Frank Mays, number 90 in black. And after he misses him initially, continues to go after the ball carrier, allowing the secondary group to come up and finish off Elmore in the backfield.
Second and 17 after a big loss. Q throws. That one is received at the 43-yard line. Caleb Davis with his second catch of the day. Got a lot of it back there. A good second down throw from Q.
Yeah, they brought pressure on the quarterback, and they didn't get to him. South Carolina State did a good job of picking up the weak side blitz. And anytime you've got linebackers blitzing the quarterback one-on-one on your wide receivers versus defensive backs, good throw by Richard Q.
Makes it 3rd and 8, a little bit more manageable after the 9-yard pickup on 2nd down. Bulldogs trying to convert on 3rd down for the 4th time tonight. Q rolling away. Fires, it's in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, Tamarik Hemingway, and a flag comes in. This one likely against the defense.
You got to know, as a defensive back, they're calling them close tonight. Any contact at all, and there will be a flag, I guess, for both teams, offense and defense.
Pass interference. Number 6 is defense. Spotted the foul. First down.
Looked like a defensive stop for FAMU, but George Elijah Maxey called for the pass interference.
And he's clearly... This is where it's going to take place right here. I mean, I think he's got every right to try and come around the wide receiver and make contact with that football.
Back to the ground on 1st down as the handoff goes to Charles Brown. It's actually Ashton Jordan. A couple of different running backs you'll see in there for South Carolina State. Jordan with the carry there.
And that pass interference there, I mean, that's one of those game changers. You've got a team... You do your job. They're getting ready to punt the football back to you. Now South Carolina State is able to keep the drive alive, get the ball across midfield. Now you're really putting a lot of pressure on your defense to come up with another defensive stand.
2nd down play action. Q heaves it deep. And that one nearly ran down by the defense. Jonathan Pillow getting the start at the safety position tonight. He almost tracked down that pick.
And this is what you can't do. You've got a free safety here. He's reading your eyes. You've got man-to-man coverage right here. If you're going to make that throw, you got to look the safety off. Look at the safety. He's looking, breaks on the ball. He's got a better chance of making that interception than the wide receiver does covering Good job by the defensive back of knowing he had free safety help on the inside, funnel the wide receiver to an inside release, and then showing good ability to stay with him stride for stride.
Third down, Q in the air again, and this one out of the reach of Caleb Davis. It'll be fourth down, and Florida A&M holds defensively again. Ever since the Bulldogs scored on the opening drive, both offenses have been quiet.
And that's the head scratcher right there. You wonder why. You've got Q throwing an incomplete pass out of bounds, standing on his feet. No pressure in the pocket. Just decided to make a poor throw with the football, poor decision on the coverage. And the offensive struggles continue at the quarterback position for Coach Buddy Pugh and the Bulldogs.
Punt team is out. Nick Belcher will kick it away. It's Lennon back deep. High kick. Lennon runs away from it. That took a favorable bounce for South Carolina State. They knocked that one inside the 5-yard line. So FAMU left to deal with some poor field position. We come back on ESPNU.
Bob,
still 7-0 in favor of South Carolina State. 10:03 left in this first half. College Football Daily is your destination for FAMU pinned back inside their 2-yard line for a good punt. Nick Belcher. Rattlers trying to get out of the end zone, and they just barely did. Eddie Rocker looked like he was going down for two, but at the last moment, a second effort, got him past the plane.
What a great effort by Rocker. Trying to make a cut, nowhere to go. Huge wall of white defenders, but keeps his balance there, keeps the knee off the ground. Able to pick up 1 or 2 yards when there was absolutely no place to go when he initially got the football.
Well, it looked like he was going down when that left foot got snatched away, and he was still able to use his hand to stay on his feet. He got two, and it's 2nd and 8. Back to Rocker. Slipping by, and Rocker drags the pile to the 15-yard line. Gain of 11 and a first down for FAMU.
Great job by the offensive line of Florida A&M responding to the challenge, knowing that you just got to put your helmet down and get tough with somebody in black jerseys on white jerseys, allowing the Rattlers to pick up a crucial first down to give them a little bit more breathing room.
Drive started at the 2-yard line, now up to the 15. It's been a slow start for Damian Fleming, 4 of 9, 23 yards, but Rockers picked up the slack. See FAMU with 63 rushing yards. Looking to pass, Fleming finds his man. The 21-yard line. Catch made by Lennon, redshirt sophomore. Mason Harris dragged him down, the quarterback with the tackle.
The emergence of Linworth Lennon is really made this offense for Florida A&M pretty difficult to defend. They know Travis Harvey's the go-to receiver, but Lennon has emerged. 3 touchdown receptions on the year. He's become a good complementary player to Travis Harvey and trying to help solidify this wide receiver core. He's just a sophomore, so his best football should be ahead of him.
Caught 6 for 134 last week. 2nd down, the handoff. Faked, kept by the quarterback Fleming. And he wiggles his way to the 24-yard line. Andrew Carter with the stop. Third and short coming up for FAMU. They have not converted on 3rd down yet. But Jay, they haven't had many 3rd down situations where they were this close to the 1st down mark. Need about 1.5 yards on this 3rd down pickup. Call it 3rd and 2. See right there, FAMU 0-for-4 on 3rd down. Eddie Rocker's the deep back. Give to Rocker. He gets the first. Crashing his way through to the 31-yard line. Rocker picks up 7 and a 1st down.
They needed that one just when I was going to question why show your hand with the power formation with the fullback in the backfield. South Carolina State, where is the defense on the perimeter? Not a white jersey at all. Anybody can see daylight to the outside. An easy 3rd down conversion for the Rattlers.
First time they have converted on third down today. It's Lennon in motion. Team's almost even with first down so far. Give to Rocker. Trying to wiggle away. Does. Just for a moment, though. It's actually Owens with the carry. There's a flag down on the play.
Hold it. Number 88 in offense. 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
Tight end Michael Etheridge, 6'2", 230-pound junior with the holding penalty.
We're keeping Clement Hall pretty busy thus far in this game. Both teams need to cut down on these penalties. Penalties in the first half. Second half, you get penalized this amount, that'll put you away and seal the deal.
Especially on FAMU's side, Jay. Are you surprised by this score?
I am. I thought they had just figured out the chemistry that they wanted offensively. The defense has done a decent job, but offensively struggled to get the ball past midfield.
Got Owens in there again, a tailback. Four receivers for FAMU. First and 20, Fleming's going to try to get rid of it. Lots of time. Leaves it off for Lennon. Shakes the first man. And Lennon back near the original line of scrimmage, a 9-yard pickup.
And this is when you have to believe in your quarterback. If you believe you have the best quarterback in the conference, and show it, put the ball in his hands. He's going to make good decisions, throws over the top of the line. That's where being almost 6'5 helps. Hit the receiver in stride. So if you're a potent offense and you're really throwing that thing around the field, you don't get intimidated with first and 20. You know, you figure that's going to give my quarterback three chances to throw the football and pick up the first down.
Second down and 11 here, and as Fleming starts to pick it up, Jay, what are some of the things that you're seeing improve here that you like about Fleming?
Decision making and the ability to throw the underneath route and hit the receivers in stride.
Dumps it off here. Owens with the catch. A stutter step. Owens a spin move and near the first down marker.
Great job here out of the backfield on the screen pass, getting it over the defensive line and then act like a running back. A la Barry Sanders and Gale Sayers, staying on your feet, spinning, juking, making guys miss. James Owens showing he's got a little bit of that extra shake. You'd like to see a good running back.
You don't see too many guys lunge backward, Jay. Pretty impressive from James Owens.
And kept his balance.
Third and a couple. Rocker back in at the tailback position. He gets the handoff. Looking for some room. Trying to lunge to the first down mark. It is a little short, it looks like.
And that's the adjustment there. You know, we talked about earlier when they went to the power formation with the I formation, there was nobody on the outside. Well, this time they go with the fullback in the backfield. South Carolina State makes the adjustment, knowing where they were last time. So the reason why you question that is you took the ball out of your best player's hands, which is Damian Fleming, trusting his decision making. Now fourth and one, they're going to punt the football away.
Justin Hughes, who was shaken up earlier on a play, making the tackle there. Hughes returning as Holdren will punt on fourth down. Murphy waits for it. That one sails over his head. And it's knocked down at the 10-yard line. So FAMU continues to deal with not scoring so far in this game. South Carolina State still ahead, 7-0.
We know you. We know you have to rise early and work late with not enough sleep in between.
South Carolina State with a 7-0 lead on the road at Florida A&M. Take a look at Jay Walker's power rankings.
So that time of year, North Carolina Central, first out on the bubble. Henry Frazier's got a really good football team. They're starting to get closer to cracking my top five. I'm becoming a believer. Number five, Rick Comegys has Jackson State playing good football. Alabama A&M, they were number two last week. They got beat at homecoming. How do you do that? They dropped to number four. Number three, Steady Eddie, Arkansas Pine Bluff, slowly but surely winning the game they're supposed to. Number two, Wildcats, Bethune-Cookman. Brian Jenkins' squad is winning the game. They're one of the premier programs in the MEAC Conference. And number one, no surprise, they've been there for a while, getting kind of boring, Tennessee State, Big Blue, number one in my power rankings. But they lost today to Jacksonville State, so Coach Reed better give me a phone call, lobby for them to keep that number one spot.
Tennessee State going down. Can't leave them in the number one spot, Jay. They're done. Give somebody else a try.
You lose in overtime on the road versus a very good Jacksonville State squad. We can talk about it.
All right. First down and 10, South Carolina State back on their own 12. They lose a yard there with Jalen Simmons. Bethune-Cookman's playing well. They were number two. Maybe a new number one next week.
Got a good chance at it, you know, for Bethune. You know, they're rivals, Florida A&M. And if Florida A&M can win this game, you know, I said it all along, that Florida Classic at the end of the year would definitely mean something.
Second down and 11. Pendergrass in at the running back position. Q looks to throw. Wall was closing quickly as Q tried to float it out to Pendergrass. That one out of his reach. Bit of an overthrow there from Richard Q.
A little bit surprised to see them coming out throwing the football right now. You got to look at the game manager right now. 3 minutes, 34 seconds. You're backed up. Q's playing efficient today, 18 of 12. But if you don't convert right now on third down, Florida A&M's going to get the ball back with plenty of time left, including good field position. So the Bulldogs need to have a sense of urgency in trying to convert on this third down.
He is at six different receivers with his eight completions. Third and 11. Hugh, the pocket closing, rolls away. Still on his feet, but can't get the first. He runs out of bounds. About 3 or 4 yards shy of the first down. Marvin Ross was the closest defender for FAMU as Q got some yardage there, but not enough to keep his offense on the field.
Now, what a job by the defense for Florida A&M. They played really good in this first half, confusing South Carolina State. Defensive coordinator Earl Holmes is doing the job. They're getting the ball to the Rattlers, keeping the Bulldogs out of the end zone ever since the first drive. They made the adjustment. And that's just a matter of maybe special teams can jumpstart this Florida A&M offense.
This might be the first opportunity for FAMU to get some real solid field position. Belcher punting from inside his own 10. Edworth Lennon. Fair catch called for and made at the 40-yard line. So Florida A&M watching their defense succeed so far. Earl Holmes, the defensive coordinator, happy. But his team down 7-0.
Team is not something you do alone. Team is plural. Team is arms, legs, blood, sweat, and soul.
Coming up on the State Farm Halftime Report, join Matt Schick in the gang is here in the studio looking at number two Florida rolling today. The Gators get a big win. Get an update on Braxton Miller's condition, a scary injury in that Ohio State-Purdue game today. A thriller at the Big House between Michigan and Michigan State. And you trying to get their offense going. Cool gadget play it looked like for a moment. But no throw on the other end from Travis Harvey. Looked like he was ready to toss it downfield. And Harvey knocked out of bounds by Courtney Ingram as he picked up about 7 on the play.
And that was a great decision by Travis Harvey not to throw the football. You're going to see Harvey's going to come here. They're trying to do the double move here, the stutter go. But good job by the defense. And Harvey does a good job. You see the stutter move? It's not there. Safety picks it up. Tuck it, run, pick up any type of positive yardage you can. I'm sure Coach Taylor's glad he decided to tuck that football and run.
Lennon goes in motion. James Owens in at running back. Second and 3, swings it out to Owens. Owens trying to stay on his feet and get that first down. He's close. Looks like he's got it across midfield at a 49-yard line. It's Davius Chestnut who made the tackle.
Owens is showing that if you get him the football, he can make some good things happen for you, particularly out in space in the open field. 5'9", 180 pounds, doesn't have a lot of size, but he's very difficult to bring down one-on-one in small spaces.
FAMU crosses into South Carolina State territory. They haven't spent a lot of time there in this game, Jim.
You take advantage of the field position while they've got it now. Get back in this football game.
Fleming fires through the hands of Lenworth Lennon. Incomplete. Fleming started slow, but he's picked it up.
And that last pass was just a little sample of that rocket right arm he's got right there. You start to think he's going to take everything short. And they just absolutely fired a laser, which Lenworth Lennon couldn't hold on to for the first down.
How frustrating is that for you as a quarterback, Jay, to see a good pass not get caught?
It happens to everybody, but I used to tease my receivers and say, well, you want me to throw it and catch it at the same time? And I don't get their attention.
It's only the fifth play in the SC State territory so far for FAMU. And Fleming dances away, still on his feet. He lost the football there at the end. Looks like Fleming did recover it on the 43-yard line. Ball popped out right before he hit the ground. Stephen Murphy with the tackle there to knock that ball away.
Good decision to run, but not too nifty on his feet with that shake move. And goes to get the football, then fortunately he got that ball back. Trying to go down, good pop put on him by Stephen Murphy coming up, making a hit, ball on the ground. The Rattlers able to recover to keep their drive alive.
FAMU has converted on their last two third downs after starting 0 for 4. Fleming looks to pass, pocket closes, gets rid of it. That one's caught, a helmet comes off, and a first down for FAMU. A grab by the tight end, Michael Etheridge.
And this is why you want to have big tight ends. If you see the chestnut has to leave the game because of the helmet rule. But you want those big bodies there with that mask because they're going to get hit. They've got to turn their back to the defense. And good job by Etheridge holding on to that football, bouncing off the defender and picking up the first down.
Doesn't get his name called very often, but a nice play there. And another third down conversion for FAMU. That's their third in a row. South Carolina State with the clock rolling down to this first half.
South Carolina State, their second charge timeout.
Only one left now for the Bulldogs, a minute nine left in this first half. There's a new late night show on ESPNU. That's the perfect nightcap to your sports day. Unite, ESPN's first late night entertainment show, weeknights at midnight on ESPNU. I'd like to see late night with Jay Walker.
I'll leave that to Danny and the boys with the DJ.
I just mean in general, your own late night talk show.
I got enough ego as it is. I don't need that right there. I think Rich and Barry, the guys with us here in the booth here, they would agree with that.
I do notice your initials all over your shirt, on your chest, on your cufflinks.
I like the style a little bit.
That's right.
Stick around. Hang with me for a while. We'll get you there.
FAMU trying to get there offensively. They have hung a goose egg in this first half.
See Joe Taylor there, and right to his right, that's offensive coordinator Kershaw there, calling plays from down on the field, something you don't see too often in today's college football landscape.
First down, a swing pass, Owens grabs it, still on his feet. Owens spinning to the 25-yard line near the first down mark. Alex Glover with the tackle as Owens picks up about 10.
To be a good quarterback, you've got to be an accurate quarterback. And what an accurate throw on that swing pass. Not easy. So often we see young college kids throw the ball behind the receiver coming out the backfield. Fleming did a good job of leading him in stride.
FAMU a little out of sorts in a personnel standpoint. They stopped the clock. First time they have used a timeout.
This is something you have to practice. I mean, dropping back, you've got to hit him in stride. Watch him pull the receiver towards the line of scrimmage so they can get that forward momentum, and that's really what allowed James Owens to pick up the first down on that. Had he had to turn his back shoulder a little bit more to make that catch, defenders would have had time to react.
Have used that play a number of times, that swing pass to Owens, but it's still working. Why not keep going back to it?
It is, and that's one of the things in today's college football landscape. To be an efficient quarterback, you have to be able to complete that throw 9 out of 10 times. It'll make it accurate there. See, pull him to the line of scrimmage. See, he was fading away. He pulled him to the line of scrimmage. That way he's in stride, able to make the first defender miss. And that's what helped them pick up the first down.
From the SC State 25, it's first and 10.
Got him.
To the end zone, touchdown! Damian Fleming with a 25-yard touchdown pass. FAMU gets on the board. It was Ad Mason Felix. Holdren with the extra point, and this game's tied, 7 apiece. A beauty from Damian Fleming to Felix in the middle of the field.
They're coming out playing the cover two. So cover two, the middle of the field is wide open. Who's the most dangerous man? This is him right here. You've got to wall him off and reroute him. If you don't get a good bump on him right there, they miss it. Middle of the field wide open, nobody there to cover. That's like stealing candy from a baby for quarterback Damian Fleming from Florida A&M.
It's Fleming's 15th consecutive game with a touchdown pass. He's been on fire lately. 7 plays, 60 yards over his last 5 games now. 9 touchdowns against only 1 interception.
And the decision maker was there. Pre-snap read was there. Good job by Felix of running away from that contact. And for head coach Buddy Pugh in South Carolina State, the youthfulness showed up right there. They're very young. They're banged up. They've got 2 freshman linebackers, including Alex Glover, who was a linebacker there, who's just a sophomore. As you become more physical and that wide receiver tries to take that clean release, you give him a good knock 5 yards away from the line of scrimmage to reroute him. That would force the quarterback to go someplace else with the football. But those are things that you can do in practice. But until you get in game day situations, you realize how much more physical you have to be with those wide receivers running full speed down the middle of the field.
And for FAMU, that couldn't have come at a better time. 46 seconds left in the first half. That has been otherwise very slow, but we've seen Damian Fleming picking it up as this second quarter has gone on. And a 25-yard strike to even this game. From the 10-yard line, it's Pendergrass. And he brings it up to the 25, so 42 seconds and 1 timeout. See if South Carolina State tries anything here offensively. They get the ball back to start the second half.
Normally you look at it and you say, okay, they've got a timeout and this game's tied, but when you've got a quarterback that's thrown 11 interceptions on the season, you just say, okay, we're going to try and maybe spring a draw play or a run and try and take it into halftime. But what a momentum change that is. You look at what South Carolina State did, came out on fire, seized control of the game early on their opening drive with the score. Defense played well up until that point, but South Carolina State gave up the big score at the end, and now the Rattler Stadium, Bragg Stadium, which was quiet, now they've got momentum, ready to get the DJ cranked up, looking forward to the second half.
The Bulldogs finished the first half with negative 4 total yards on their last 11 plays of the half. Q takes a knee, and this game will go to halftime, but this game knotted up at 7 apiece.
Look at our schedule coming up in the coming weeks. Delaware State versus Morgan State on Thursday. That'll be a good one. Delaware State sneaking up on a lot of people. They got a victory here today. They're doing well. And next week, going to the world's best tailgate, if you ask me, Birmingham, Alabama, the Magic City Classic.
Legendary Legion Field next Saturday. We'll head over to the world's best studio in just a moment. Our halftime score, 7-7, as we take it to Matt Schick in the studio for the State Farm Halftime Report.
There are a few.
7-0 on the season. They got Oklahoma next week. Florida A&M with the touchdown. Tied it up at 7. That's where we are at the half.
This happened.
South Carolina State punches it in. They're tied with Florida A&M at the break. Second half coming up.
This halftime.
Come and enter promo code VORTS.
Generation of hitters.
Welcome back to ESPNU, College Football Primetime, presented by McDonald's. From Bragg Memorial Stadium in Tallahassee, South Carolina State and Florida A&M tied at 7. MC Light in the house, along with former NFL and Howard quarterback Jay Walker. I'm Wayne Randazzo. Jay's loving him some MC Light tonight, as we can see now. How you can get to a better state, brought to you by State Farm with Darian Fleming.
Hey, use the momentum that MC Light provided the crowd at halftime. She knows how to rock the party. Well, Damian Fleming knows how to rock the party, too. They had to learn that. He got off to a slow start, just 2 of 7, 6 yards. But towards the latter part of the first half, he showed up. He showed you what Damian Fleming's all about. Finished the half 11-17 for 96 yards. And more importantly, the touchdown strike to tie up this football game at halftime. Use some more Damian Fleming if you're Florida A&M and you want to get to a better state.
You mentioned earlier, Jay, the poise of the young sophomore quarterback, Damian Fleming. You saw it there, despite the slow start. completing 9 of his last 10 passes in the second half. But now we think about some halftime adjustments after each team only scored once in the first half.
Well, for Buddy Pough, he's got to go back to what they wanted to do earlier. Establish the run game, control the clock. Their opening drive, they ran the ball at will. Get back to running the football.
From the 13-yard line, it's Chris Merrill across the 25. So that's where South Carolina State will set up offensively to start this second half. And for the Bulldogs, a very successful opening drive, but they went very quiet after that.
Yeah, so often you see offenses today go with the scripted first 10 plays of the game where it worked to perfection for the first drive, but they faltered afterwards. And when they came out early, they used the pass to set up the run. It seemed as if they got away from that in the first half. Go back to just a quick pass and then start pounding the football, because ultimately I think Jalen Simmons and Ashton Jordan, the running backs, are going to win this game for the Bulldogs if they are to emerge victorious.
First play of the second half from the 25-yard line. And the give goes straight up the gut. Jalen Simmons picks up about 5. What were your thoughts on Richard Kue in the first half?
Well, didn't throw the interception, which has been his Achilles heel all season long. Missed a couple passes that he should have had, but ultimately give him about a C grade if you have to grade him out.
FAMU leading in total yards, penalties about even, first downs are even, and the first down here for Jalen Simmons across the 40-yard line. Big pickup on a second down run.
See, and this is when they should do the hurry-up offense, get to the line of scrimmage. You've got the personnel matchup you want. Run the ball. Get that ball snap right now. Don't let them adjust.
After a 12-yard pickup, Simmons gets it again, and he gets many more. Simmons breaks through. Jalen Simmons inside the 20. Devon Roberts pushed him out of bounds.
And I like the play selection here by the offensive coordinator McGorgan. Just get the ball to him. Don't let him make the change and substitution. They had trouble covering that zone read, and Jalen Simmons getting involved early in the second half. Seems like they're trying to follow the formula it takes, and listening to Jay Walker as an offensive coordinator, by pounding the ball with the foot running backs.
10 carries, 74 yards for Simmons. He gets a breather. Jordan's in a running back. It's into his belly, and Jordan fights forward for a few.
And that play there, although not too attractive, doesn't necessarily the game breaker that you got, it wears down the defense. You hit him with the long run, then you run hard in between the tackles. It takes a lot of energy and effort for those interior defensive linemen to make that type of tackle after running down the field. I'd go back to the run, up the middle, test them, wear them out.
Second and 9, Jordan, once again the running back. Play action, Hughes pass caught. A juke move and out of bounds at the 11, Dwight Brannan.
When you see the ability of having a running game, what it does, now he's got 3 bodies right open. He's open, he's open. He's gonna end up open eventually. When you can choose your spots and have that many guys wide open, that's because they were keyed in on the run, and Dwight Brannan did a good job on the release.
3rd and 3. That's Ashton Jordan who gets the first down pickup to the 5-yard line. It's 1st and goal to go.
Starting to just gash him in the middle. That's what you want to do. Look at that. White jerseys looking for black jerseys to hit, creating a little wall, and Ashton Jordan able to get that ball inside 7-yard line to create 1st and goal for the Bulldogs.
This is very similar to how the first possession of the game looked for South Carolina State. Direct snap goes to Simmons. He gets eaten up in the middle. It was a direct snap that scored the South Carolina State touchdown to Julius Pendergrass in the first quarter. That one snuffed out by the FAMU defense.
Yeah, it's kind of that reverse wildcat where they're snapping the ball to him, and the quarterback, Richard Kue, is coming. See, he's lined up behind the center. They don't realize that the quarterback Kue is calling out the Canes, but he's not underneath the center. They're using him as a decoy. And Florida A&M might have picked up on it, but I'm not sold 100% that they realize that's what South Carolina State was doing to him.
On 2nd and goal, play action. Kue has to roll away. Taking off, Kue. Touchdown. Richard Kue breaks away and goes 7 yards into the end zone to give South Carolina State the lead.
Good decision by Kue. I like when he got out the pocket. He determined, I'm going to run this football. Nifty footwork to get inside the pylon. Put 6 on the board for the Bulldogs.
Richard Kue does take off every once in a while, more than 200 rushing yards this season. Caps off an 8-play, 75-yard drive. Nick Belcher with the point after. And South Carolina State jumps out to a 14-7 lead. As Jalen Simmons got the ground game going with a big play, a 39-yard run to set up the score.
Up next for Career Day, quarterback Aaron Rodgers.
Richard Q on the phone after a touchdown run. South Carolina State now leading 14-7 with 12:31 left in the third quarter. Who's he talking to, Jay?
So much easier to take that phone call after a touchdown drive compared to when it's a fumble or a three and out or, lo and behold, an interception. But talk to him. He's feeling good about himself. Just tell him, the short coordinator is telling him, keep your confidence, stay focused.
James Owen from the six. Trying to go up the seam, and he lost the football. A scramble for it, and South Carolina State recovers. James Owens got popped. And South Carolina State comes away with the ball. Recovery by Mariel Cooper.
Special teams, Owens had a good first half. Turned his back to the defense on a kickoff return. That's a no-no. You cannot make that mistake. And the Bulldogs pop him. And then you'll see right here, he's going to come away with the football. Doing some good pulling there was Cooper.
Like Justin Mulgrave, who knocked it loose. South Carolina State after a touchdown. Fantastic field position. A fumble on the ensuing kick return.
And this defensive stance right now may be the most important one for Florida A&M this football season.
Give to Simmons. He's wrapped around. Brandon Denmark with a nasty tackle in the backfield.
They've got to rise to the occasion. After the special team gave up the fumble, it's imperative that they hold South Carolina State to just a field goal attempt. The way this team has been playing offensively, the South Carolina State defense has been going, I don't know. Before they will be able to guarantee they can score at least two touchdowns in the second half.
Loss of one in the run. Simmons back in there. Quick slant, ball caught. And down to the 5-yard line, Tyler McDonald, it's first and goal.
Defensive line was playing aggressive, give a quick play fake to Simmons, throw a dart, and a great job of looking that ball in by Tyler McDonald. Pick up the first down.
Q keeps it, trying to run away, does. Q to the end zone, touchdown.
Penalty.
There is a flag back at the 4-yard line. Richard Q with an excellent run and what could be his second touchdown of the game, but we'll see.
Illegal block in the back. Number one of offense, 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
Linnell Elmore flagged for the block in the black. Block in the back, rather.
What a costly penalty there by Elmore. Q seemed as if he had the angle. He was going to go into the end zone untouched. Maybe that's why the running lane was so open. Elmore with the block in the back.
Tough break there for South Carolina State. And now the ball back to the 13-yard line. Still first and goal. Q will pass. He has time. Now the pocket closes, and Q's down at the 20-yard line. Brandon Hepburn was all over it, so was Ellie Hippolyte.
You see here, they're just going to collapse the pocket. Hepburn blitzing from the middle linebacker position, and that's a sack by force. Each of those guys should get a half a sack. Good penetration. Rattlers trying to take advantage of the penalty, which took the touchdown off the board for South Carolina State.
Penalty and a sack has set back South Carolina State to the 20-yard line. Second and goal. Two sacks tonight for FAMU. Dumps it off. It's Davis. Not much to the 16-yard line. Brandon Denmark again with the stop.
Brandon Denmark's playing fired up. He seems to be the one Rattler defender that realizes the sense of urgency they must have right now on the defensive end. to try and keep the Bulldogs out of the end zone.
FAMU, after losing that fumble, how important would a stop be here, Jay?
It would be monumental, particularly when the touchdown was erased off the board.
Third and goal, low snap. Q throws. It's caught, but not much there. Knocked out of bounds. Get a couple there as Dwight Brannon with his second catch, but good defense, and FAMU holds up.
And that's another one where you obviously don't want to take a sack in that situation, but you don't want to settle for a one-yard gain down there. The risk reward to me wouldn't have been worth it. Maybe hold on to him a little bit and take off running. He had a good pocket with plenty of time.
This is Belcher from 32 yards. He's long 37. He's 4 of 6 on the year. Trying to make it a two-possession game. And it's no good. Belcher pushed it wide right. And FAMU holds up. South Carolina State, after the turnover, unable to score. And it remains a one-possession game.
The Mideastern Athletic Conference. We bring to life the dreams of student athletes. It's our vision. A premier.
South Carolina State still leads 14-7 over Florida A&M as we welcome you back to ESPNU College Football Primetime, presented by McDonald's. Let's take a look. All games bringing the flavor, brought to you by McDonald's.
We're out here. What up, ESPN? Let's ride, baby!
Are bringing the flavor, brought to you by McDonald's. Strike, strike, and strike again, Jay Walker.
Talk about the halftime here. You know, you saw the last shot there of Dr. Humphreys and getting the crowd going. And we talked a lot about what was going to occur at halftime. That's a good halftime show. And the MC Light rocked the crowd, then bringing back the tradition with having Dr. Humphreys say that strike, strike again. I don't know if there's another moment in all college football that gets the crowd so amped up to follow the words as when they were sitting on the edge of their seat to bring back that tradition. Good class.
After a big defensive stop, FAMU airing it out. Fleming going deep. And it's incomplete. Travis Harvey laid out for it, but he was unable to make the catch. That was close.
Well, this is what you have to do. You got to put some air underneath the ball so your receiver can come and try and make a play. If he keeps his footing, that's one he wishes he had back. Harvey there. You see the ball, recognize it. Had he been able to keep his footing, could have caught that ball for a big play. But that's something that so many young quarterbacks don't know. They try and throw that ball on the line drive deep downfield. Good air underneath the ball so his receiver could readjust to the pass.
On second down, they'll try to pass again. Over the middle. A check down throw to the 23-yard line. Short pickup there. Good hit. Jeremy White with the tackle.
What South Carolina State's going to do, if they're going to have Etheridge come across that formation, the adjustment has to be made. He's got to stop. You can't continue to run across that zone. As a tight end, you've got to find the first window or the second window. If you keep running across zone formations, you're going to run into a headache. And right there, you got a good pop put on him by the Bulldog defender.
Third down and 7. FAMU only with their third play of the half. South Carolina State running the first 15. Fleming trying to dance away. Finds a target. Only a 2-yard pickup. As the catch was made by Dwayne Harvey.
This is one where he wants to attack the middle of the field, but when he's got to step up and sees the white jersey that takes his eyes away from it, all he can do is do a quick flick of the wrist and try and pick up whatever he can. But that's great defense by the Bulldogs. Keeping everything in front of them with good solid form tackle.
Could have been a big momentum shift after South Carolina State was unable to score after a turnover. They get the ball right back. FAMU goes 3 and out. And Darius Drummond on the return gets pushed out of bounds. Jay Walker, give me 5.
All right, here goes one for you. How about 5 legitimate HBCU prospects? And obviously on the bubble, Kadarius Lacy from Alabama A&M. We'll see him next week. Keewon Riley, All-American free safety, Alabama State, big-time playmaker. Number 4, Dub, they call him, Jamal Johnson-Webb, offensive lineman from Alabama A&M.
Take a look at a flag here, perhaps.
During the return, blocking the back, number 8 on the return. 10 yards penalty from the end of the catch, first down.
Number 3, Rodgers Gaines, Tennessee State offensive lineman, 6'7", 320 pounds. They're talking about him. He's the reason Tennessee State's having success. Number 2, Teron Armstead, 6'5", 310 pounds, runs a 4.8 40-yard dash, NFL potential. Number 1, he's also the number 1 rated FCS player, linebacker Keith Pugh from America's Black College, Howard University.
I sense some bias, Jay.
Normally there is. Be quite honest, everybody knows that, but in this case, he actually is the number one ranked FCS player. He's the all-time career leader in tackles for loss in FCS history.
Number one's Howard, numbers 2, 3, and 4 offensive linemen. I sense quarterback bias, I sense a Howard bias.
I put a DB in there. This is
nowhere to go for Julius Pendergrass on that first down run, maybe a yard. Big hit by Hepburn. He's a pretty good linebacker.
Hepburn's a very good linebacker. You know, but 3 offensive linemen that are legitimate tackles that people are talking about, that's something to be said. And all of them have a common denominator. They got great size, great footwork.
Second and 9 after a 1-yard pickup. He has to get rid of it quickly. The blitz was coming. FAMU likes to blitz. And they jumped on top of Richard Q. He had to get rid of that ball quickly. Good pressure. Devon Roberts, the safety, coming up to get in Q's face.
And that was a good job by Q of just having the ability to get rid of that football. Pressure is on him when they bring Devon Roberts up from his strong safety position. He's there to cause bad intentions. Q got rid of it just in time to hold on the football and give him third down.
Third and about 8. Charles Brown in at running back. Low snap. And that ball knocked away. Davis, the intended receiver. Devontae Terry Johnson knocked that ball away. I haven't called his name yet tonight. But Johnson slapping that one to make it fourth down.
So that's the second possession for South Carolina State in the second half. And after looking so good in their first possession, going right down the field, they're going back on track like they did in the first half, getting stopped on their second possession. Let's hope that's not a sign of things to come if you're a Bulldog fan.
Well, what's the difference? Why the success on the opening drive of the half and then nothing else?
Sometimes it's just that fire. You go out there and you drive down, you think it's going to be easy, and you don't give the defense credit for making the adjustments that what you made in the first half.
Nick Beltrue boots it away on fourth down. One bouncing near the 15-yard line as it goes out of bounds. ESPN College Football is available anytime, anywhere on your computer or mobile device via WatchESPN.com and the Watch ESPN app. How many apps you got, Jay?
Not too many now. I'm gonna need a couple more gigs. How about you? You a techie?
A little bit. South Carolina State, Buddy Pugh. Had a lot of success. Both of these coaches, really, Jay, they've had tremendous success. Long tenured coaches throughout the MEAC.
Good guys, and they've seen a lot of football, and they've engaged several times in classic battles like this.
First down handoff, Eddie Rocker. He gets soaked up after a yard or two.
And this is what Joe Taylor wants to do. I mean, if he had his way, he'd line up in that I formation, give him a good running back or two, and pound the football behind that lead fullback. And right now, when he's only down by a touchdown, he can still go to his philosophy, which is to have the ability to run the football in between the tackles with the power running game. They've struggled throwing the ball at times tonight, so he's going to try and force feed that run.
Second down, they spread it out again as they have most of the night. Fleming looks to pass, fires over the middle, and it's nearly picked off. That one hit Kamario McFadden right in the knee. As it ricocheted through the middle of the field, McFadden couldn't grab it.
Trying to squeeze this ball in a very tight window.
Good job by the linebackers of getting depth, then reacting on the ball. You see the tip ball hung in the air. Mario McFadden should have come away with that interception.
Now third down, South Carolina State. Held FAMU to 0 for 4 start on third down conversions, and then the Rattlers began to convert. They need 9 here. Fleming trying to buy time. In trouble, Fleming goes down. Dragged from behind by Curtis Hill. And FAMU will have to punt.
See what Fleming sees with the pressure coming. Wants to step up, but that white jersey's right there. Good job of sidestepping the first tackler. But too many white jerseys moving their feet around the football while the Florida A&M offensive line is standing around watching.
Brandon Holdren's been busy tonight. Left-footed punter. Left-footed punter. Drummond with a fair catch at the 40-yard line. And South Carolina State's defense continues to hold up. FAMU with a late first half touchdown. That's been it. This time Curtis Hill making sure Damian Fleming couldn't go anywhere.
With the season about to tip off, college basketball's buzz revs up with Media Days.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is brought to you by Lexus, introducing a stunning work of technology, the entirely new Lexus ES. 14-7, South Carolina State maintaining the lead, 5:43 left in this third quarter. Bulldogs, their opening drives of each half succeeding for touchdowns and not much else otherwise. 22 plays, 135 yards in the opening drives. Not even half that. Every other possession. Grounded here to Charles Brown. Brown with some running room as he gets to midfield. Just a yard shy of the first down. Pickup of 9.
And getting back to what they should be able to do or have the ability to do versus a 3-4 defensive front. Run the football, run to the bubble.
Another running play here and a lot of room up the middle for Brown. Across the 30, Charles Brown gets the first.
See, this is when we know South Carolina State likes to keep the personnel in there and run the same play over and over again. They gave Brown one carry there, another one, and over pursuit by the safety coming up to fill the hole. That's Devin Roberts. He's in that trail position.
Low snap, Simmons grabs it on a bounce. And he tries to make something out of that as he picks up 3. Well, Jay, when you look at those first 2 drives of each half, this is how they did it. They ran the football effectively.
And this is why they said their game plan was, we have to run the football. They said, we know we're struggling throwing the ball, but it's not all the quarterback's fault when we've been so one-dimensional. And this is probably the best that the South Carolina State running game has looked all season.
2nd and 8. Chris Merrill is in at running back for the first time. Hugh fakes the handoff, dumps it off to Elmore, who couldn't hang on to it. Elmore got smacked after the play.
Now back in the old days, there would be no question that would not be a penalty. In today's college football, surprise, they did not call the penalty. But I remember coaches used to always say, well, that's what you get for dropping the ball when you get popped.
Patrick Aiken did the popping.
It wasn't that hard.
Might have been a flop instead of a pop there, Chad.
Tell him catch the ball next time. You won't have to worry about that.
3rd and 8. Cue the fade. It's juggled and knocked away. Caleb Davis had a shot for 6, but he couldn't bring it down.
Wow. Great route, great separation. Good pass, but Caleb Davis, you got to catch this ball the first time. You see, he didn't catch it the first time. Allowed the defensive back, who was beat on the play, to come in there and separate him from the football. If he catches that the first time cleanly, he goes in for a touchdown grab. Instead, becomes a long incompletion. And can't fault Richard Q for that.
This would be, by far, Nick Belcher's longest field goal this season. It's a 44-yard attempt. His previous long, 37. He's missed from 32 tonight. He would have missed that one, but a flag comes in.
Now, seeing the way he missed that one so bad, I wouldn't be surprised if this is against Florida A&M that you decide to go for it.
Clement Hall is our head official tonight.
If this becomes fourth and three, you've got to think on the road that they may consider going for this.
Offside, number 54 of the defense. 5-yard penalty, still fourth down.
Brandon Davis called for the offsides. How do you jump on a field goal attempt?
Yeah, the ball's in front of you. You've got to see it.
Especially one from that deep where you just make the kicker do what he can do. But now fourth and three, so do you go for it, Jay?
I mean, I personally would. You saw how he just shanked it. You know he's going for a career long right now. You're on the road. You know, you got to do some things outside of your normal when you're trying to get a tough road conference victory. I mean, he missed that last field goal attempt by 15 feet to the left.
Even with the penalty, it would still be a season long for Belcher. This one from 38 yards. Q is the holder. And Belcher extends the South Carolina State lead. His longest field goal this season, a 38-yarder. That's 17-7 in favor of the Bulldogs.
Took advantage of the mulligan. Plus, they moved it a little bit closer.
Nick Belcher. 38-yard standpoint, Buddy Pugh happy with the offsides penalty, turning into 3 points. Six plays, 28 yards. Now South Carolina State leads by 10 as we take a look at the Sheridan Broadcasting Network top 10.
Tennessee State on top, but there may be a change with their loss. Winston-Salem, Division II, up to number 3 in the national polls there. They may occupy the top spot. Bethune-Cookman, their loss coming to Tennessee State and the University of Miami. They're there. A&M didn't drop as far as I thought they might have, but watch that team, number 5. They're on the rise. North Carolina Central, Henry Frazier has those Eagles playing above their head. Then you see the rest of the top 10 with Morgan State at number 10. We'll see Alabama State taking on Alabama A&M next week in Birmingham, be number 4 versus number 8 in a game that we know is going to mean something.
Magic City Classic next week. James Owens waits for the return from Will Roper's kick. Now FAMU, Jay, finds themselves down by 2 possessions.
It's time for them to step on the gas pedal and find their identity. Are you going to throw it or are you going to run it?
Owens will run it from the 1-yard line. Looking for some help on the sidelines. Owens got ripped there at the 36-yard line, but a nice return of 35 yards. It was Chestnut who drilled it.
And for Florida A&M, they've had the ball in some pretty decent field position at times during this game, and they've only got 7 points on the scoreboard to show for it.
FAMU now will start this drive back at about their own 37. So does the philosophy change with a 10-point deficit?
Look, I think you give it one more drive, but you know, I ultimately at this point would say I'm gonna trust the game to my best football player. If you truly believe it's Fleming, let him do it. But he hasn't helped his cause. He's almost thrown a couple interceptions tonight.
Only 3 yards in this entire quarter for FAMU, and they get even more than that on this run. Eddie Rocker picks up 4. Leon Smith with the tackle there, and it's 2nd and 6. Damian Fleming's had sort of an up and down game. One of his best games last season, if not his best, was against the Bulldogs. Completed 34 of 40 passes. Hasn't been quite as accurate tonight. They run it here. Rocker again on the right side. And he gets a couple of yards. It'll be 3rd down and about 5. Curtis Hill with the tackle. See next week's schedule, Delaware State against Morgan State on Thursday night. in the Magic City Classic, Alabama State, Alabama, A&M from Legion Field in Birmingham. You getting your menu ready for next Saturday in Birmingham?
Yeah, I gave up barbecue for like 2 weeks in
just
anticipation
for
of that game.
Third down, it's Leonard in motion. Fleming over the middle into traffic. The intended receiver, Harvey, looking for a flag, but no dice. Murphy breaking up the play.
Once again, the Rattlers start with decent field position, unable to cross midfield to sustain a drive down the field. And South Carolina State Bulldog defense doing a good job of confusing the Rattlers offense.
FAMU just looks a little lackluster offensively.
I agree with you.
Drummond and Murphy are deep. Holdren just barely got that one off. From the 12, Murphy slips. BCS Countdown is on ESPN and ESPNU. This Sunday, a day after the dust has settled, our analysts break down the key victories and defeats that took place on the college football gridiron and discuss their impact on the standings. Plus, we look ahead at the key matchups for next week. BCS Countdown at 8:30, then at 9, presented by Tostitos. Sunday on ESPN and ESPNU.
This is that time of the football season where every win becomes magnified. Once the BCS standings come out, then you've got to measure those wins. And I always thought the team that really in pretty good position is LSU. I mean, they're outside at top five, right at the number six, and they've got the teeth of their schedule in front of them. If they win out, they could be playing for a title.
So they're going to have to go through Alabama as Jalen Simmons gets to the 20-yard line, and then he's driven back, so extracurricular after the play. Hepburn, part of the drive back for Simmons. Well, South Carolina State with a 10-point lead, and they've run the football effectively, Jay.
I think Florida A&M has to leave their comfort zone and start bringing some blitzes. And even if you just call blitzes designed to stop the run, with South Carolina State having some success running the football, if they have the ability to do that and not have any repercussions, and they're just going to continue to do it.
Well, they're hoping to get Jalen Simmons more carries. Buddy Pugh has stuck to his game plan. Here's Simmons again on third down, but he won't move the chains. He loses a yard. FAMU with an impressive defensive stand there after it looked like Simmons was going to easily get the first. Picked up 9 on the first two plays, but couldn't finish off the drive. And now Brandon Davis with the tackle to get FAMU the ball back.
And they need to do something. I mean, special teams need to do it. This place is flat. I mean, right now, they're just waiting for something to happen. The only spark they had was a touchdown right before the half. They had momentum going into the locker room. That's gone now. And everybody's just sitting around waiting for something good to happen for Florida A&M.
Belcher will punt. Pretty good-sized crowd. They made a lot of noise on the lone touchdown near the end of the first half. Running up and fumbling. Lenworth Lennon does recover on the 39-yard line. That was almost a dangerous play for FAMU as Lennon muffed the punt. But a new drive begins now for the Rattlers.
Gumbo. Oh, I'm going to get some gumbo.
Is Jay Walker a year ago at the Magic City Classic.
Now we're talking.
I promise the family wouldn't eat as much this year.
Quarterbacks aren't supposed to eat like that, Jay.
Yeah, but you see how good the food is I'm tasting there? I mean, my face says it all.
That's a pig.
The whole pig on the grill.
What was the best food, though?
The ribs. For the barbecue.
Oh, look at that. Magic City Classic. Looks like a good time. That's next Saturday. Fleming airs it out. Nobody near it. Harvey, the intended receiver.
Magic City is more than a good time. It's a great time. I've never seen a game where you get 70,000 people in the stadium, 35,000 people outside the stadium, tailgating all over the place. And every year they seem to take it to another level. And when both teams are playing well, ranked inside the top 10. It's something special.
Should be a good game, great rivalry, a great atmosphere at the Magic City Classic next Saturday morning. Second and 10, Owens in a running back. It's Lennon in motion. Fleming gets rid of it, finds Owens, setter step and a few yards there for Owens. Swing pass not really working as it did as much earlier.
Now, I do like the fact that they're throwing the ball and keeping it in Fleming's hands, deciding to kind of say this is how we're going to win it, but getting a little tired of the swing pass to the left, swing pass to the right. I'd like to see him call three vertical passing plays in a row down the field.
They don't use the middle of the field very much. At least they haven't tonight.
Yeah, and maybe that's quarterback's design. You know, he's very picky when he's going to take his chances. But the middle of the field has been open all night.
It's 2 for 10 on third down. They need 6 here. Last play of the third quarter. And there's the middle of the field and a first down. Florida A&M connecting on a first down pickup to Felix. And they're down by 10 entering the fourth quarter on ESPNU.
Team is not.
South Carolina State using a big third quarter, running the football effectively. 104 rushing yards and a touchdown. The third period on the ground for the Bulldogs.
We knew that was going to be the coaching adjustment they wanted to make. Buddy Pugh dialed up the running game, and Jalen Simmons did a good job of responding. And then quarterback Richard Pugh, nifty little move there to get into the end zone.
South Carolina State with a 17-7 lead over Florida A&M as the fourth quarter begins. Q, 102 yards in the air with that rushing touchdown. Fleming's been so-so, 15 of 25, and Jalen Simmons, a big game, 14 carries, 87 yards. It's Richard Q watching on the bench. He's done his part tonight. He's managed the game. No turnovers from Q. Play action, Fleming trying to get away. He does, still on his feet. Fleming cuts it back. Whoa. And gets popped at the 26-yard line. A big hit from Courtney Ingram.
Woo! That's the second time we've seen Ingram deliver some wood. In that case there, you like the competitive nature of Fleming, trying to get all he can get, trying to show some athleticism, but he gets bent backwards there. He's too valuable to this Rattler offense to take shots like that.
Sometimes it's okay to slide.
As a quarterback, this is where you hope they call the running play. You don't want to do too much thinking after getting hit like that.
They do run it to Rocker on first down. Tries the right side and gets a couple. It'll be second and 8. Glover and Hill on the stop. Getting late now into this fourth quarter. FAMU's only touchdown came at the end of the first half. They scored with 46 seconds remaining in the second.
Attack the middle of the field. They've had success when they go there.
Second down. Fleming scrambling. He finds Lennon. Lennon dancing inside the 10. And it's first and goal.
Good job by Fleming buying time, getting outside the pocket. Then you're going to see Lennon just sit on the sideline. Park, come get the football. Make a couple guys miss.
He was just hanging out. Now first and goal in FAMU. Trying to draw closer in a 10-point game at home.
High formation, follow the fullback. You'll normally see a collision. Him right there.
Lock at the fullback. Behind him, James Owens. Owens pushing inside the 5. The play stopped there. Hughes held him up.
James Owens. It's one of the things I miss about the old I formation, those fullback collisions, taking on middle linebackers in the hole on the wham play. You don't see that too often in today's college football landscape.
Second Second and goal, and for one of the few times tonight, a lot of noise.
If I was South Carolina State, I would locate number two, Travis Harvey, and make sure I have at least two defenders close by.
Owens, the lone setback. Fleming looking, lofting, and it's out of bounds. Too far as Fleming hit the deck. And it's third and goal.
They decide to go with the drop back pass. Five-step drop on the four-yard line. Not going to have a lot of time as a quarterback. Throw that football in there. Fleming takes the pop for it.
Javon Hargrave, the true freshman with the pressure. Go back to the fullback setup here, Jay.
If you don't do it on second down, I don't think you do it on third down.
It's third and goal. Harvey's up in the corner. See if Fleming looks for him.
Got one-on-one down low.
Looking that way, Fleming tossing, and it's caught. Touchdown. Second strike tonight for Damian Fleming. This time, Lenworth Lennon with his fourth receiving touchdown of the season. Chase Varnador with the extra point attempt. It's blocked.
That's big.
So instead of pulling within a field goal, it was Curtis Hill who had his paws in the air. Varnador's extra point blocked. And Florida A&M gets closer. Damian Fleming clutching the left arm after his second touchdown of the night.
Stand up to her.
No, you're not.
I know.
You know, Ronnie, folks who save hundreds of dollars switching to Geico sure are happy.
How happy are they, Jimmy?
Happier than a witch in a broom factory.
Get happy. Get Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
With a 5-star overall safety rating and Scion Service Boost complimentary maintenance plan, the Scion TC is made to handle the streets.
I have no idea as to how I'm going to be paying for college.
I'm the second oldest of 14 children.
I'm currently working 5 nights a week.
I am paying for law school on my own.
Let me tell you about my goals, my ambitions.
I'm really passionate about human rights policy making.
I want to help a lot of people in my life,
start my own business.
I want to make an impact on my community.
I'm pleased to present you with this check for $100,000.
Dr. Pepper is giving away over $1 million in tuition. Share your story at drpepper.com. The Dr. Pepper Tuition Giveaway.
College football lives on ESPNU. Our experts review the big wins and devastating defeats and look ahead to the top matchups.
It's one thing to have to play with your backup quarterback. It's another thing to have to go into a hostile environment.
College Football Daily, weekdays at 1 on ESPNU.
With the season about to tip off, college basketball's buzz revs up with Media Days.
There's a whole new energy. There's a whole new zest.
Coaches and players open up to talk hoops, break down X's and O's, and preview the long and arduous road to Atlanta.
It is incredibly difficult, and how he does it, the way he does it, is amazing.
College Basketball Live Media Day Special, Thursday and Friday at 2:30 on ESPNU.
Are you behind on your mortgage payments? Could your house go into foreclosure? Does it seem like the bank has no interest in helping you save your home, and you feel like you have nowhere to turn? Then we have good news for you. Homeowner Protection Services. Homeowner Protection Services can help save your home. We specialize in foreclosure assistance, and that's all we do. If you're behind in your mortgage payment.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by McDonald's. I'm loving it. State capital of Tallahassee. Here in the Sunshine State, South Carolina State leading 17-13. For Florida A&M, 12 minutes, 10 seconds left with a big blocked extra point. South Carolina State up by 4 instead of a field goal.
And that really changes the dynamic of your offensive play selection. You're thinking you've got to get into the end zone compared to just thinking if you just move the ball, worst case scenario, you kick tie with a field goal.
Pendergrass trying to take it up seam, and he gets to the 27-yard line. As we take a look, the MEAC standings coming into this weekend. Lord A&M tied for third with Howard. South Carolina State tumbling early.
And Norfolk State, the defending champion from a season ago, winless in conference play. Hampton struggling, so that means the Tidewater area is really not getting it together. It'll be interesting. The team to watch, Delaware State, 2-1. Big victory today. They're going to go to 3-1 over North Carolina A&T. So Kermit Blunt has the Hornets with some sting back in their stingers.
Yeah, it was Norfolk State and South Carolina State at the beginning of the season, Jay, that were favored in this conference. They've combined for one conference victory so far. The end around, handoff to Davis. Caleb Davis across the 35 with a nice game.
Jet sweep run by Davis. Good timing on the quarterback snap so he could get that ball to Davis in stride and take advantage of the leverage he had on the outside perimeter of the defense.
No huddle and a handoff to Ashton Jordan. He gets the first down to the 40-yard line. About three there. South Carolina State able to move the chains. Trying to eat up some clock here. Still a tight game, one possession. FAMU putting together a touchdown on their last drive. And in motion is Elmore. Simmons up the middle. Trying to spin away, and he gets to the 49. Close to the first, a pickup of about nine. That run by Jalen Simmons, who's been a workhorse today. They wanted him to get more carries, Jade. He certainly has.
He's doing it and staying true to form. Whenever they hit you with a big run, and they like the look and the personnel, hurry up to the line of scrimmage and call another running play.
It was Q trying to run it this time, and that was a messed up play. It's second and one. Now it's third and six. Hippolyte in there with the stop. What do you call here, Jay? Third down.
I think you try and get yourself a crossing route, which is where they've had some success doing it. And if you see catch the Rattlers being too aggressive, you cannot be afraid to take a shot up top.
Q looks to pass. Rolls out. Trying to get away. Gets rid of the football. It's caught. Flag comes down. Catch was made by Hemingway at the 45-yard line, short of the first down. See what this flag is.
I think they may call a face mask on the defense. And even so, Q, I don't know how he was able to see Hemingway open on the sideline.
Looked like he just tossed it up, but all of a sudden Hemingway was standing underneath.
Yeah.
Personal foul, face mask. Number 52 of the defense. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Sean Hepburn.
And at the end of the run, doing a good job of hawking him down, but he grabs and then goes to the ground. That's dangerous when that happens.
See the line judge throw it immediately. Big penalty. They mark off the 15 yards and it takes South Carolina State all the way to the 30.
And if I was South Carolina State, I would be wary of the Florida A&M blitz right now. Once you get the ball in this part of the field, defense has become very aggressive.
First down, a handoff. It's Brown stumbling through the line. Brown across the 25. He gets about six. Hippolyte dropped him down.
Brown's come in and given this running game a little spark. Seems like he's got those fresh legs, not have a lot of carries on the year.
We've seen Brown, Pendergrass, Simmons, and Jordan all get carries tonight. Chris Merrill's in there now as well. Low snap. It's Brown again, but a whistle.
Oh, they're going to say that Q's knee was down on the snap, which would be a big break for Florida A&M.
Yeah, I guess that's the call. Third down. Q back at the 30-yard line, went down to the knee, handled the low snap.
Yeah, see, we've had these low snaps a couple times. He goes and get it. Oh, that
didn't look like
his knee wasn't on the ground. Then it was a fumble as well.
It's third down and 10. Q gets rid of it. He's got an open receiver, but he throws it over his head. Hemingway, the intended receiver, he was wide open.
And they had the protection. Although Florida A&M brought the blitz, as a quarterback, you have to know when you're protected. I mean, they've got this picked up pretty good. He's got time to step into the throw. Great job by Hemingway of turning around the defensive back. That's just when you got to put it right on him when he gets that wide open.
Well, Nick Belcher has hit a 38-yard field goal tonight, which is his new season long. This one would blow that one away from 47 yards. Looks good. It is good. And Nick Belcher from 47 puts South Carolina State back up by a touchdown.
They're up by a touchdown, but they know that the better throw could have easily been more. Missed opportunity to put this game away. I mean, this is where your tight end is going to be. Let's take a look at the move. Look, just a little rub. They blow the coverage. Merrick Hemingway's wide open. He can't get any more open than that. Coming from that inside slot position. The Rattlers dodge one. South Carolina State could have really seized control with a touchdown throw there.
8 plays, 48 yards on that drive. Turns into 3. Bulldogs finally win one of these games on the road. They've been on the road a lot this season. Maybe this one getting interesting with 8:52 to play. FAMU about to get the ball after a Nick Belcher kickoff. Now, if you're the Rattlers, Jay, how do you come out? How do you approach this drive?
Keep everything in front of you. Try and see if the pressure gets to Florida A&M, knowing that they're down by 7. Stay off the blitzes, play firm up front, and just keep everything in front of you. Form tackling.
Owens is back deep. After a 47-yard field goal, Belcher lets it fly. 2-yard line, Owens. Trying to find some room up the seam. He gets through the 35. And he's caught from behind at the 37. 35-yard return for Owens and a good start for FAMU. Down by 7. There's a whistle and a player down. Charles Brown, we've seen him get a couple of carries on the offensive side, playing special teams here. Brown being tended to at the 22-yard line. FAMU will have decent field position here. Damian Fleming, who's had it together on a couple of drives tonight, not all of them certainly. He's been inconsistent, but a chance here to bring his team back.
And I think the offense as a whole has been inconsistent, as we see Charles Brown get to see him jog off under his own power off the field. They've had good field position. I mean, rarely have they been pinned back deep. For an offense with this much firepower, they should have more points on the board. Fortunately for the Rattlers, they're still in this game, only down by a touchdown.
Just 145 yards passing for Fleming tonight. Trying to get rid of it on first down. He's in trouble, and it goes down just behind the line of scrimmage. South Carolina State defense has gotten to Fleming a couple of times. It was Hargrave, the true freshman, with the pressure again.
And I think now this is one of the few times I've seen in Fleming's career where the rush has gotten to him. He's starting to look at the defensive line with the defensive pressure. Look at that.
He's got a big number in the third quarter in favor of South Carolina State, helping them get this lead, 20-13.
Pump fake. Fleming taking off again. He only gets a few yards out of bounds. Stephen Murphy drove him away, and it'll be third and long.
And this is one where, you know, because they've gotten pressure, I don't know if he's letting the play develop. We'll see the rush, the pump, not there. Settle. Settle right there. Take a step to your left or right, but because they've gotten to him, it looks like he's reading the rush. He actually scrambled to the right side. There were no wide receivers on the right side. They called that play to flood the left side of the field. He scrambled to the right, nowhere to go. I really do think that the Bulldog pressure and the hits on the quarterback have gotten to Damian Fleming tonight.
Would you blame that on inexperience?
But he's got enough starts under his belt. I just think they've done a good job of rattling him and confusing him with some of the looks.
It's third down. Fleming fires, and that one is holed in on the sideline. First down catch for Lenworth Lennon.
And that's what he can do well. You know, when he knows where he's going with the football, extremely accurate. Give him a pocket, nobody able to get to him. He picked a target and basically said, this is where my pre-snap read is taking me. I'm going to take it. And he had a strong enough arm to take it from the defense, even though that was pretty tight coverage.
Gain of 11, and now FAMU approaching midfield. Rockers the deep back behind Lockett. Hand off Rocker. And wait for a hole to open, and he does break through to the 45. Ball came out. South Carolina State thinks they have it. They do have it. Bulldog ball. A fumble from Eddie Rocker and a big turnover as FAMU was driving into South Carolina State territory.
Well, that one's going to hurt. Joe Taylor come on the field. He may want to challenge this. Let's take a look. He goes down.
He wasn't down yet.
Nope. And it was the way that the tackle was finished by Stephen Murphy with the wrap. Turned him around before he put him to the ground.
Yeah, you could see Rocker was parallel to the ground when the ball came out.
And then this one's going to hurt, you know, for the Rattlers. It's going to sting a little bit.
Well, they're going to review this one, FAMU, hoping that they get the football back after a fumble from Eddie Rocker. Well, it's under review, and what appeared to be a fumble certainly looks like a fumble from this standpoint. Stephen Murphy knocking the ball loose.
First down, South Carolina State.
And South Carolina State does get the call in their favor, but at FAMU, they had to challenge that.
Yeah, at this point in the game, because you think if they score just another field goal, then right away, not only are you competing against South Carolina State, you're competing against the clock.
The replay officials have done a good job today.
Gotten the call right.
Up the middle, a lot of room. Jalen Simmons across the 35. Big game for Simmons on the first play after the fumble in the FAMU territory.
They're trying to do that hurry up. Again, once they gash with a big play, they like to line up again, get you in formation, and see if you figured out what you did wrong.
Another give to Simmons, not as much room this time. A couple of yards. Patrick Scott.
Well, here, just a zone read, and good job by Tamarick Hemingway being the decoy running back, pretty much. Just got in the way. But Simmons had a big game. We said he had to play well tonight. Help with the running game for South Carolina State, and he's responded to the call.
Second and eight. Fake handoff. Q rolling left. They'll tuck it and go out of bounds inside the 30.
And that's got to be disappointing for Earl Holmes and the defensive staff for Florida A&M. You call the blitz to try and stop the run, but yet you still let the quarterback get outside the pocket, pick up positive yards.
Inside of 6.5 minutes, FAMU could use a stop. Earl Holmes, the defensive coordinator, needs to draw something up on this third down.
I'd bring the pressure. You got to try and create something.
Give it to Simmons. He tries to roll out of that tackle, but he's short of the first. He picks up three. It'll be fourth and two. We've seen some issues with the snaps tonight for South Carolina State.
Yeah, going down ankle high. Good job of getting that. Look at Simmons just run through Jonathan Pillow, who's getting the start at safety because of the injury to John Oho.
Well, Nick Belcher's had a good night, two field goals. And they've been some long ones. Missed the shortest of his three tries. This one's from 43. Trying to make it a two-possession game. That one's blocked. It's loose. Picked up by FAMU. Special teams comes through for the Rattlers. Marvin Ross got the hand up. Bobby Jackson able to run the football down. And FAMU gets the big stop that they needed.
And watch it. They're going to go for the block. Easy penetration. Good job of coming around the edge by Marvin Ross. I mean, they've got two black jerseys that are in position to block that field goal. You know, and I think they called that because previously on the field goal attempt that Belcher made, they eased off. And I thought they could have gotten the block, but they obviously called a field goal safe.
We talked about the snaps on the offense. That snap wasn't that great either. First down, there's a fumble, but right into the hands of Rocker. And a yard there as Eddie Rocker had that ball right out of the hands of Tyler Bass, who is in at quarterback. Damian Fleming out of there, and Bass, the senior out of Memphis, checks in here underneath 5 minutes.
This is interesting right now. Fleming is on the sidelines trying to warm up. We saw him take some shots like he was favoring his left shoulder. Looks as if Coach Taylor's not going to chance him. Going to bring in Bass, see if he can get the senior to spark some offense.
Potentially a big moment for Bass. Passing on second down. Fires that one in. Catch made by Rocker. Rather by Felix as he gets to the 45-yard line.
Bass came to Florida A&M. He was supposed to be the starter a season ago. Highly sought after transfer. But with the play of Damian Fleming emerging as a freshman, he's been relegated to a backup role. But now here's a chance to regain some of that glory.
Each team 4 of 12 on third down. This will be the first third down attempt for Tyler Bass. And FAMU wants to stop the clock. 4 minutes remaining. And Damian Fleming sitting on the sidelines with his team down by one score. Doesn't look like he's in bad shape. 18 of 29, 156, and two touchdowns.
He's been getting hit a whole lot, but here's what I'm talking about, that block field goal. On this long one that he made, watch the guys ease up. You see he had that step there, and he eased up off of that. And I'm pretty sure that Marvin Ross disarming, oh, I've got the edge. I can get there. So this time is not going to be an ease up. He's coming across the formation, both, and they get there in a hurry. So that was good recognition, them going back, telling the special teams coach, I can get to it. Don't call the field goal safe. They came up with a huge block to keep the Rattlers in this football game.
Now they have the ball with 4 minutes left. Down by a touchdown even after the timeout. It's Tyler Bass, the senior backup quarterback, replacing Damian Fleming. Bass stands in the pocket, fires and connects. Across the 45, Dwayne Harvey. And a first down for FAMU.
So Bass picks up the first down and talks about him being a highly sought after transfer. He started out his playing days at Memphis. And there was kind of a question of where he was going to go to. Florida A&M landed at that time, was considered to be the big prize. This is before Damian Fleming emerged, and now he's got an opportunity to come in here and show what all the hoopla was about.
See the numbers. He hasn't been out there often, but he's been accurate when he has. Rocker trying to turn the corner. Does break from the first set of defenders, and he gets a couple of yards.
See, I'm doing hurry up right now. I would be doing the hurry-up offense because there's no guarantee you're going to score the touchdown. And if you don't score, you at least want to put yourself in a position where you may be able to get the football back. And if you're not going to do hurry-up offense right now, when you look at the clock down the distance and all the other situations, and you've got to be thinking this is going to be the final drive of the game. So it becomes four down territory from here on.
Plus, the Rattlers only have one timeout. Blitz on second down. Bass leaves it up for Owens. First down yardage. Owens across the 30. James Owens inside the 10. All the way. Touchdown.
We mentioned earlier that James Owens had a little wiggle, a little pep in the step, trying to redeem himself after the fumble. Did a great job of running after the catch.
Owens, the MEAC's leader in all-purpose yards. What a great run after the catch. The extra point attempt this time is good. And it's all tied up, 20-20. With 2:37 remaining, and it's the backup quarterback, Tyler Bass, with the touchdown pass.
Doing his impression of Tommy Rees. This is a hot read. They bring the blitz. They don't get there. That means you've got one-on-one coverage across the field. Poor tackling in the secondary. This last cut right here makes it a foot race, keeps his balance, leaps, gets it to the end zone. So what you're going to see, this is going to be Bass here, but the key is watch the pressure they're going to try and bring from the outside. Once that happens, you've got man-to-man coverage here. The tackler has to come from all the way inside here. It's a lot going on that play. Get rid of the ball quickly, get to the outside, and it becomes all James Owens after that. The great effort deep, not settling for just a long game, but taking it into the end zone.
Tyler Bass celebrating a touchdown pass to tie the game. He gets pressed into duty, Jay, and he comes through.
Yeah, what is this? We saw Notre Dame pull it off a couple of weeks with Tommy Rees, and now Tyler Bass just making the hot read. That's a great job as a backup quarterback to be prepared. He hurt him earlier with a nice completion down the field. South Carolina State decided to not allow him to get comfortable, bring the pressure. And if you're going to blitz a quarterback, that means you've got man-to-man coverage in the secondary. The Rattlers took advantage. Now, listen to Jake Gaither. Stadium.
From the 12-yard line, Pendergrass still on his feet. And up near the 40, a good return. Well, now the onus on to South Carolina State, Jay. 2:28 remaining. They've been running the football well, but in a situation where the pass might get called for here, they haven't done that a whole lot tonight.
If you're South Carolina State, go back to your scripted plays you call at halftime. You've got all three timeouts, which I think is huge for South Carolina State. Having those timeouts, you can run the football, but call your best plays, and there's a sense of urgency.
See A&M with one timeout. Keep it on the ground. Jalen Simmons to the 43, gains four.
And that's good. That's what you want to do. Get your 4 yards, keep it going. I think the plan is simple here. We're going to run the football, try and eat up some clock and gain some field position. Florida A&M, you're not getting the football back.
Back to the ground on second down. Simmons this time has ripped backward. Brandon Denmark in on the tackle.
And this is one here where the quarterback didn't make the right read with the zone read. In man line of scrimmage, he caves down. Quarterback, you've got to pull that ball and take it around the outside.
Looking for a pass on third down. Hugh hits his target, but it's out of bounds. Caleb Davis couldn't get the foot down. And South Carolina State will have to punt.
Wow. This was close. I thought he caught it clean. That foot is out of bounds. That was a great catch and coverage.
So FAMU, after a game-tying touchdown, will get the ball right back. Lennon waits for it at his own 15 off the foot of Belcher. Minute 33 and one timeout. Lennon comes in, waves it off. That one bounces inside the 25, and it's held down at about the 23. So FAMU, one timeout, 1:23 remaining in a tie game. And it was a blocked field goal, Jay, that turned it around.
They knew they could get to it. They came around the edge. Two black jerseys in position. That kept it to just a touchdown lead. And then Tyler Bass, the backup quarterback, comes off the bench, reads the hot read, becomes a touchdown, and all of a sudden we've got a tied football game. And the defense did their job. They got the stand. And you know what I think is going to happen, what's really going to hurt? There's a minute 22 left. If they don't throw incomplete on third down, Florida A&M would have got this ball back with less than a minute to go and only one timeout. Minute 22, that's five or six offensive plays you can run, and they've got a timeout, so this is going to be interesting.
That goes right back to Tyler Bass, the senior backup quarterback for sophomore Damian Fleming. Pump fake on first down. Good time. And it's dropped. The intended receiver, Owens, second and 10.
Wow, Tyler Bass had Linworth Lennon running wide open down the seam. Seemed to be a little timid there on that drop. Now, one thing you lose when you bring in Bass compared to having Damian Fleming in there, we know Fleming doesn't throw interceptions. Tyler Bass, as he tried to become a hero and force something, you want him to play within the system.
Coming up immediately after our game, it's the Lexus HBCU postgame report with highlights and analysis for tonight's game, followed by SportsCenter U and all the news from today's college action. Second down, Bass going back to the air. A wobbler, but it's caught. Lennon to the 39-yard line, a first down. FAMU has to move quickly. They only have one timeout.
Clock will stop as they set the change for them so they can stop the clock. And then once it's set, call the play now. You want that ball to be snapped within 3 or 4 seconds of the quarter of the referee blowing his whistle.
Bass has time. And another completion to Linworth Lennon near midfield. Tyler Bass.
See, that's not a first down, so now you've got to hurry up and get the team up there and go for the clock. You either got to clock it or sneak and get the first down yourself. But don't let all this time tick away. Oh, no.
Down to 40 seconds. On second and one, some miscommunication.
Oh, wow.
And now Bass is going down.
Yeah, they got to call timeout. That's the difference you get in having the backup quarterback in there compared to the starter, which is surprising because, well, normally the backup is pretty well versed in two-minute offense. They get a series of that. He got confused. Second and one. At second and one, you should be up there either going to clock the ball, get underneath the center, clock it, or snap it. Miscommunication. He gets hit. That's the last thing you can do in that situation, is a tackle for loss with the clock still running, forcing you to burn your last and final timeout.
It's like Courtney Ingram down on the field at about the 39-yard line. So we'll take a minute to look at him. 31 seconds left. Florida A&M had to use their last timeout after that broken play. So now what?
You've got to try and go for the first down. You can't be afraid to throw the football. Fortunately for them, they stopped the forward progress at only 1 yard loss. A good look there at Quinn Gray, the quarterback coach for Florida A&M. He's an NFL veteran for so many years, played forever, it seemed like, in the NFL, played for the Jacksonville Jaguars, Indianapolis Colts, one of the all-time greats in MEAC history. So I'm sure he's talking to Tyler Bass, telling about the situation, how to be careful.
Like that could be Damian Fleming. Left shoulder all bandaged up, ice, and a towel draped over it. So Tyler Bass takes over for the evidently injured Fleming. Bass already with a game-tying touchdown. Trying to pull FAMU all the way back. 31 seconds left, no timeouts. It's third and three.
And If you're Florida A&M, you've got to be thinking they probably need about 22 yards to get into field goal range. It all starts with trying to pick up this first down on third.
Plenty of time over the middle. Knocked down.
We're
going to roll that a fumble. At the 46-yard line, recovered. Now there's another official saying incomplete. And that's what it's going to be, an incomplete pass. Over the middle to Lennon, who had it for a moment.
I mean, ball was thrown right on the money.
Boy, if he'd have hung on to that, Jay, it would have been a huge play.
What an aggressive play call to go that far down the field. But that's, you got to take what the defense gives you. If they were giving you the same throw.
Fourth down, Holdren will punt. No chance you go for it here, I wouldn't think, Jay.
No, no. You're playing at home. You want to just try and pin them deep somewhere. Good special teams play.
And added 4 seconds to the game clock, 25. 25 remaining. South Carolina State hasn't used a timeout in this second half. Probably not a factor here, though. This game on the big punt return. Could be headed for overtime. Good kick. And it's taken by Drummond. He watches that one sail into the end zone, so a touchback. 17 seconds left. South Carolina State probably just sits on it here.
You know, you would think that, but they've dodged so many bullets, you almost start to wonder with the three timeouts there, 17 seconds, but knowing Coach Buddy Pough the way I've traditionally known him, this is one where he tries to win this game in overtime. Consider this, you've got a team at home that's got their backup quarterback in the game. So you've got to think advantage South Carolina State with them having their starting quarterback still available to them. And Florida A&M, led by head coach Joe Taylor, basically season lingers on the line in the hands of Tyler Bass.
Well, you got to say Tyler Bass has stepped up to the challenge. He's been cool and collected in the pocket, and he's been pretty accurate. They will take a knee, and they will send this game to overtime. FAMU with a touchdown the last 3 minutes as Tyler Bass connected on a long pass play. And we're headed to OT, 2020, South Carolina State, Florida A&M on ESPNU.
Cool, I won again. Monopoly at McDonald's is awesome. 1 in 4 are winners. Hard to beat those odds.
I can. I'm moving to San Diego.
Why?
It's the luckiest city in America. It's got the most sweepstakes winners and the fewest lightning strikes.
Doesn't matter where you are. Still 1 in 4.
Just the same, I think I prefer San Diego.
It's the 20th edition of Monopoly at McDonald's, and 1 in 4 wins. With over $300 million in cash and great prizes, it's the most prizes ever. The simple joy of winning.
With the season about to tip off, college basketball's buzz revs up with Media Days.
There's a whole new energy. There's a whole new zest.
Coaches and players open up to talk hoops, break down X's and O's, and preview the long and arduous road to Atlanta.
It is incredibly difficult, and how he does it, the way he does it is amazing.
College Basketball Live.
Well, we start overtime, 20 apiece, South Carolina State to Florida A&M. A little bit of controversy over the coin toss.
Oh, but this is a huge controversy. South Carolina State wins it. So Buddy Pough says, we want to go on defense first, but the captain head out there said, we'll take the ball. Maybe the momentum got him. So in overtime, typically you want to be on defense first. Instead, South Carolina State's going to start it on offense, not the way Buddy Pough wanted to get this thing going.
And here are the rules that certainly favor the team that gets the second possession, because you know what happens in front of you. Each team gets one shot from their opponent's 25-yard line until the winner is decided. No game clock, play clock only. You have to go for two starting in the third overtime. Well, here we go. South Carolina State, the first play of OT. And up the gut, Jalen Simmons running hard yards after the hit as he gets inside the 15 and then goes down. Flags come in after a late hit.
Simmons did what he was supposed to do. You keep running to the whistle, and once the whistles were blowing, for some inexplicable reason, the Florida A&M defense lifted Simmons off the ground and body slammed him into the turf.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Number five of the defense. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
It's on Patrick Aiken.
And listen for the whistle. Wow. But throwing aside, now, right now, this part of the position of the field, this is where having the ball first makes all the difference in the world.
First and goal. Simmons bounces out, looking for the end zone, leaping. Touchdown. South Carolina State gets six. Jalen Simmons with a leap into the end zone. Had to wait a while for that call. But the Bulldogs strike first in overtime.
Obviously, I'm sure they're going to take a look at this one. It's a touchdown automatic, but he leaves his feet. Does he get in? Elbow down. He placed that ball into the end zone. He's up in the air, elbows down, balls. It hit kind of simultaneously. I think that touchdown will stand.
Looks like it won't even be reviewed as Belcher's out for the point after. He knocks it down. Jalen Simmons, 22 carries, 144 yards, and now a touchdown in overtime to give South Carolina State the lead, 27-20. On the FAMU side, Damian Fleming taken out of this game.
Yeah, he took a lick right there, and that was early in the contest. He continued to play, but then they were just driving him to the turf time and time again. And then once he makes his touchdown throw, watch him walk off the field. He's going off, and he's trying to tough it out and stay in there. Ultimately, the pain just became too great.
The left shoulder seems to be the problem for Fleming. And now Tyler Bass, the senior backup, takes over on the 25. FAMU needs seven. Pump fake. Bass in trouble. Throws it out of bounds, and it's second and 10. Tyler Bass has one game-tying drive tonight. We'll need another to keep FAMU from a disappointing home loss. The loss could be even greater if Damian Fleming is out for any extended period of time.
One thing we saw from Tyler Bass, he can throw the ball with some velocity down the seams. I would try and set up maybe trips to one side, spring somebody up the seam, because you got to give your backup quarterback some surefire throws that he can step into.
On second down, Bass swings it. James Owens with the catch. And Owens lunges across the 20. Obviously, four down territory here, Jay. They need a touchdown. After South Carolina State scored to start this overtime. All Damian Fleming can do is cheer on the sidelines. Watching his team try to battle in OT. On their home turf, down by a touchdown. They've struggled on third down today, both teams have. They need five. Bass floats it. A catch is made inbounds. Great effort by Lenworth Lennon. And a big first down for FAMU.
This is big time. This is NFL. That catch there made by Lennon on the sideline. I mean, you're taught, secure the football, then your bottom half of your body just goes dead. You just want your legs to go limp. He did a good job. Otherwise, his momentum would have carried him out of bounds. Make the catch and then just drag that foot. Great job by Lenworth Lennon.
A new set of downs from the 12-yard line.
Fullback's in the game. Follow the fullback.
Locker behind him. He gets the handoff. Locker got smacked. Big hit. Courtney Ingram again. We called his name a few times for just this.
Big hits. You know, he knows there's going to be a collision around the fullback. Wait for him in the hole. Drive through Rocker.
Ingram, a senior, 5'10", 190, but he fills the middle of the field, the linebacker spot for the Bulldogs. FAMU needs a touchdown.
Watch Travis Harvey here on the bottom of your screen, a big play wide receiver.
Pass with time. Now the pocket collapses. Bass goes down. Javon Hargrave, the true freshman. In fact, it was his hit earlier in the game that really set Fleming back. He gets to Bass here.
You see Bass trying to go to his left, and it's what you can't do when you're in a battle of field position. Cannot afford to take that sack. Right now, things are looking good for the Bulldogs, and the guys on the sideline are feeling that much closer to coming in here in the Tallahassee and maybe escaping with the victory, but they got to get two plays, two stops right now.
FAMU needs to get inside the four for a first down, third and 16. Catch made at the 15-yard line. Looks like Lenworth Lennon again, and now it's fourth and about 11. FAMU will need to convert with the game on the line.
Keep in mind, they can still get a first down if they can gain 11 yards, so they don't have to score a touchdown.
Hey, we got Lennon's down, and there are two Rattlers down. It's a lineman on the field. Lennon has popped back up, so the lineman's the only man down. He looks to be in some pain as we take another look at the MEAC standings heading into this weekend. And South Carolina State in need of a victory.
And everything above them stayed the same. Bethune-Cookman victorious, Howard victorious today. Florida A&M now 3-1. See, can't afford to get in that two-loss column. There's not enough weeks left in the football season for you to probably get back into it with two teams that are undefeated in conference play at the top of the standings. South Carolina State trying to play for pride pretty much at this point. Good job by the Bulldogs coming down here playing with a chip on their shoulder.
Strength of the defense for South Carolina State has been their defensive line. They've certainly stacked the box tonight. Cut down Damian Fleming's night short. Now Tyler Bass, the backup quarterback, the senior, trying to finish off a comeback. He got it to overtime. Now he needs a 4th-and-11 conversion. So he checks in on the sidelines. Damian Fleming, not where he wants to be.
Yeah, this is one where you're, when you're Fleming, you've got that experience. You've got to be over there in the huddle, talking to the coaches, talking to Tyler Bass. When I played earlier, when I did this, I got this look. You know, that's that communication you want to have. So he should be right in the middle of that huddle right there, talking about what he saw earlier, what he's going to do.
The injured lineman, Zeri Patterson.
He's a true freshman that had to step up because they had some issues on the line with their depth. So now we're going to have your backup lineman in there. But keep in mind, once again, you see there that says 4th-and-11. It's not 4th-and-goal. So that gives you the opportunity. You can call a curl combination if you want to. But I would like to see them come out in some type of trips formation and attack the seam. That's been there. Whenever they go trips, they know the look they're going to get. They can stick the ball down the seam.
South Carolina State trying to break a four-game road losing streak.
They're in the trips, all their motion into a double. I don't like it.
Fast passing. Fades it to the end zone. It's out of bounds. And South Carolina State gets an overtime road victory. They hold off Florida A&M 27-20, the final. South Carolina State improves to 2-3 in MEAC play, while FAMU falls to 3-2.
Rattlers fought themselves back into this game, but ultimately, after the sack in overtime, came down to a fade pattern that was thrown out of bounds. It's a look here. They had to try and stick that fade versus a cover two look. One-on-one, and so often we've seen that happen. And look at the reaction from Coach Taylor and offensive coordinator Kershaw.
Once again, our final score, 27-20, as South Carolina State pulls off the win in overtime. We'll be back in Tallahassee with the HBCU postgame report brought to you by Lexus right after these words.
The Mideastern.
Time now for more analysis on tonight's game with the HBCU postgame report brought to you by Lexus. 27-20, the final in overtime. South Carolina State gets the win on the road at Florida A&M. Big win for the Bulldogs, who break a four-game losing streak. And South Carolina State using their legs today to get the victory. Wayne Randazzo and Jay Walker from Tallahassee. And Jay, big win for South Carolina State. Their ground game was very effective.
You knew that's what they had to do. Coming into tonight's contest, they struggled at the quarterback position. What's a quarterback's best friend? A running back that's running the ball well. Jalen Simmons, over 140 yards, including a touchdown, had 116 yards in the second half to seal the deal for the Bulldogs. He was phenomenal, got it done, really helped out this Bulldog offense, and this is the type of performance they need from him from throughout the rest of the season for the Bulldogs to have a chance of having a 500 year.
What next now for FAMU? Damian Fleming gets hurt at the end of that game.
Yeah, they've got to figure out what's going on with the quarterback position. Tyler Bass came in and got him a touchdown drive to take this game in overtime. But for Florida A&M, they had an opportunity to control their own destiny, 3-1 in conference play, dropping a tough home loss in conference play at this stage of the season. Maybe too much for the Rattlers to recover, but you never know. It's been a crazy year in the MEAC Conference, and the Rattlers need some help from some supporting teams.
South Carolina State gets a big road victory in overtime, 27-20, as they knock off Florida A&M. That's it for the HBCU postgame report brought to you by Lexus.
This is SportsCenter U.